Hello, everybody! Everybody party! How you going, everybody? Welcome to OneCoin Only, the place where I talk a lot of shit and get paid for it. Best job in the world. Hope you guys are doing great. We are doing some beat-em-ups today because I'm feeling lazy. That's all. Let's have some fun. Beat 'em up game today because I'm feeling lazy as fuck. So we're doing Moonwalker, Hyperstone Heist, Final Fight CD, and Streets of Rage 1 today. And then if we still have a big room, we still gotta get Jeffrey McNair's bonus game on. How you going, Brandon? Good to see you. Shorty LeBeau, good to have you. Thank you for coming in. Happy Friday, guys. I got my coffee here, but I'm probably going to get Super Poor to make me another one when she finishes shower. So yes, it'd probably be yes. Hey, I'm Maddie. Thank you for coming in. Craig David. Good to see you, Craig David. How are you? Oh, boy. Yes. I think I'm going to buy a stronger coffee next time I go to the supermarket. I need one that's going to make my head go pop. Jesus juice. Well, I mean, hey, you know what? You can... I certainly consider coffee to be called that as well. Yes, Dick Force. Absolutely. I mean, if the shoe fits, as they say, right? If the shoe fits. Hee-hee, Jamona. If you're here until the end, you're going to enjoy the bonus game today, Josh. Hope you're doing great, brother. Damn, I'm doing absolutely dreadful here right now. Man, I just let it go. Oh, is it really? Let me fix that. Thank you very much. Yeah, there's no way in hell that... No, it says Shoei's a 7,500. The fuck are you talking about? What are you talking about? It says that Shoei's a 7,500. It says 7500 on the screen. I don't know what screen you're looking at. There you go. You're going on the cunny list for giving me false information. How you going, Daniel? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Fucking hell. Oh, good on you, Brandon. Hey, man, I'm glad it all worked out, bro. Excellent. All right. I understand. Well, I can solve that problem very easily. There we go. That not going to be a problem anymore. There you go. Michael. How you going, Kid Jackson? Thank you for coming in. Ryan, welcome to the stream. I knew you'd be in here, Kid Jackson. You're never going to miss an MJ stream, right? One day when I'm feeling like it, I'll do the Sega Genesis version again. But I like this one. It just gets straight to the point, really. How you going, Stephen Young? Good to see you. Damien, thank you so much. Give me 1 second. Cunny, are you okay? Are you okay, Cunny? Cunny isn't okay. He's an asshole. Anyway, Damo, this is going out to you. I mean, it only seems appropriate right now. Nikki Torres, thank you for the 100. Nikki Torres, have some bishes. Thank you so much, homies. Great start to the day already. Oh, we unlocked a Star Party challenge. Look out. Look out. We've only been here 2 freaking seconds. Chrissy Ogle with a big 500. So just a heads up on Shoei's. This time round, I've replaced the whiskey with soju. Now the soju's more alcoholic by about over 20%. So each Shoei's gonna be about 1.7 standard drinks instead of 1.4 standard drinks. So 5 or 6 of them and I'll be in bed like face down, you know what I mean? So The shoeys are the normal price, but they're more alcoholic at the moment. Chris, thank you very much. Give me one second here, Chris. Ryan says, Ricky is the best streamer in the world. Man, I'm just happy that people like to watch it. At this point, I'm just like, whatever, hey. Going out to you, Chris. Thank you so much. Yes, Star Parties equal bonus games. That's right. Zemo says I should do the Michael Jackson dance instead of the hot dog dance. If I start grabbing my nuts and thrusting, I'll get cancelled. How you going, Tommy? Good to see you. Yeah, thank you very much, everybody. No, I think I'll stick to the hot dog dance. I'll quit while I'm ahead. Or behind, depending on how you look at it. Yeah, I'll quit while I'm ahead, behind, whatever you want to call it. So Chris says he made some Euros with cheese fries. There you go, you're having that Greek souvlaki, huh? Good for you. Nigel says, Shimon, some bitch. Good to see you, Nigel. Very good evening. Very, very, very good evening. I'm all good, man. I'm just getting my head in the zone. I want to thank everyone that came in and watched the boxing game with me this morning. I know it's a little bit more obscure, but there are a lot of people in there that were good sports. We had some good fights. I'm the North American champion when it comes to boxing. I became the North American champion this morning. I had a three-way series with a guy called Jamie Peterson, I think his name is. He looked like Postman Pat. But we had a three-way series and we ended up retaining the North American Championship. I kind of sound like NXT now, don't I? But yes. It was a good time. Man, Steven says, where did you get Undisputed Boxing game from? No, it's not on PS5, only Steam at the moment. It will come to console once it's out of beta. Yes. So anyway, this is going out to you. Thank you very, very much. Thank you, Steve. And Damo also with the big 500. Damo, we're going to do this one for you. Randy, we love you, Damo.
We love you, Randy.
Make love to me, Randy, please.
Wow.
And we're going to do this one for you. Shorty Banks also with the 100. Actually, we have to do this one.
Good morning, my neighbors!
Good morning, my neighbors!
Fuck you! Yes! Yes! Fuck you too!
There we go. Look at Rick showing his appreciation for all the kind star donations right now, hey? Only on OneCoin only will you be abused for sending stars. How you going, D Dilly? Good to see you. Jermaine's in here. Dude, it was a best of three series. And the first two fights we had were an absolute freaking war. And then the third fight, I sent Jamie Peterson straight to freaking retirement. So take that, Jamie, you dog. Guys, if I'm missing any comments, please don't be offended. Don't forget, copy and paste as your friend. We've only just started, so the hype is real at the moment. I haven't missed any donations, have I? I'm very grateful for all of them, guys. But yeah, I just felt a bit lazy today. Just a recovery day, so we're doing some beat-em-ups. Got some freaking good ones on the list, though. By the way, Joshy King, my capture equipment's working now. Did you want to try turtles again tomorrow? If you want to try turtles again tomorrow, Joshy, I am down. Oh, I won't let you go down again. Just let me know. And so you just... Oh, you're not talking to me.
Michael.
Oh, goodness. Oh, yeah, let's do our little dance moves here. There we go. Yeah, sure. So I've set up my old capture card, the one I used before the broken one. And then my new one's also arrived. So no matter what happens, I have two capture cards now. So I'm not going to have this problem ever again. But if you want to do turtles tomorrow, Joshy, let's do it. Let's do it. I'll message you again like 5 minutes before we start. Then after we play Turtles, against my better judgment, I might do some Cuphead or something. Might do some Cuphead afterwards. I'll probably live to regret that decision, but yeah. And so Fushi says redundancy is critical. Really? Who got redundant? Zemo says, what's everyone's favorite Michael Jackson song? Man, I've got a few, but this one's pretty close. This one. I used to play The Way You Make Me Feel a lot when I first started DJing. I used to play The Way You Make Me Feel a lot. And I like a lot. When it comes to some of the later stuff, They Don't Care About Us is another good one. Yes. You gotta go with Thriller. Thriller's one of the all-time great party jams, but that's not my favorite MJ song, but it's like one of the all-time great party jams. Almost at 500,000. Oh, yeah. Shit, I was gonna be like 500,000 people. Like, oh, star donations. Man, I was gonna say, if we got 500,000 people in here, we're bigger than WrestleMania. Hey, one day one coin only will be bigger than WrestleMania. Imagine if we got bigger than WrestleMania. That ain't gonna happen, but hey, you need to have big dreams or they're not big enough. Imagine if we were bigger than WrestleMania. Yeah, well, I mean, that's what happened before, but then the other one broke and then, yeah. But, you know, I now have two working ones. I might make a reel of me smashing the one that's broken with a sledgehammer or something, just for views. You probably have a few people that agree with you on that one. Yes. I also like Off the Wall, actually. Dangerous is my favorite album. I know you're probably like, what? With all the awesome MJ stuff that came out beforehand. But yeah, Dangerous is my favorite album. Easily. I'll never forget it. My 10th birthday. It was either my 9th or 10th birthday. I got the album. And I was like, yeah. How you going, Sean? Good to see you. I can catch a morning stream. Oh yeah, I'll be on, bro. I'll be on. We'll have a good time. Damn it. Yes. No, I want to smash the old capture card with a sledgehammer and try and get views. Smash it, get some views. How you going? Who else have we got in here? Thank you everyone for watching. As I said, we're just warming up really strong with this one. Then we're going to go to the other stuff. Don't forget, if you want to support for free, guys, hit the thumbs up button. I do appreciate that, guys. There's no algorithm on OneCoin Only anymore. So literally only the people that watch OneCoin Only are going to get a notification. No one else. So, but basically we're like the 300 basically at OneCoin Only now. We're just gonna keep swinging until the very end. Probably the best way to explain it. So, consider the OneCoin Only stream like the 300. That's what we are now. We just gonna keep fighting for as long as we can. How you going, Kenny? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Hope you're doing great, Ken. I appreciate you very much for coming in. Yeah, Michael says you love the description, flying fish. It just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it, Mikey? That would be pretty awesome. What's everyone's favorite Weird Al song? Either Amish Paradise or White and Nerdy. Yeah, either Amish Paradise or White and Nerdy. Hey guys, we've got the Fields and Friends in here. Steve and Young Anthony are watching from work yet again. We got a big shout out to the Fields family and friends. Good to see you guys. Thank you for coming in. Yes. Nah, for me, Amish Paradise, and then, yes. Oh, what was the other one? Yeah, White and Nerdy. And Mad Rotala, yeah, we're playing Michael Jackson today. Yeah, you cannot fire missiles. The problem... Dude, you know what? I wish you cunts would stop backseat gaming. I know you can fire missiles, but there's nothing worse than charging up an attack only to get shot 3 times before you use the attack. I don't need any... You know what, Invader? I'm so sick of you. Fuck you and your backseat gaming, man. You should know better. Bye-bye. God damn it, man. Fucking if you know how to play better, start your own stream, you dumb fuck. Oh my gosh. Way to put me in a bad mood and backseat fucking gaming, you cunt. Anyway... Just let me play the game. No one cares that you're an expert. No, that's okay, Adam. How you doing? I'm good. I'm in a good mood, but I just have zero tolerance for peasants. There we go, we got this. Hey, go on, Adam. Thank you for coming in. Yes. I haven't had a good little rage in a little while, so there you go, everyone. There you go. You're welcome. It has been a hot minute since I've had a good little rage. Hey, go, hey, Space Coast Gaming's over on TikTok. Thank you, man. I've been reposting a couple of your videos lately, bro, because I've introduced a new format. So thank you again for all the videos you made me before, bro. I've got another Joshy King video uploading tomorrow morning as well. We're going to be doing a part 2 of Blaster Master. Yeah, no, I appreciate that, Josh. Thank you very much. Bye! Then shall we? There you go. It's all good. No, it's okay. I'm not going to pretend I'm an expert, but I mean, no one likes a backseat game. That's all I'm saying. I will say this. This particular area is a good area to use a charge shot. This area is a good place to use it. It's a little bit easier to use it here. Thank you, Joshy. Thank you so much. We're going to scream. You know what? We're going to do this one for you too, bro, because we need to get some hype in here. Thank you, bro. Yeah, I actually have a Shoei Starscream. No, Nigel made us a Shoei Starscream. And I'm really, really sorry, Nigel. That's the one thing I've forgotten to load. Fuck, I feel terrible. No, Nigel's made us a Shoei star screen. I just haven't loaded it yet. Thank you, babe. Oh, hello. Do you come with a Shoei? All right, well, as long as you do. Oh, gosh.
Boom, boom,
Alright, there we go. We're going to beat this level. And yeah, nah, I feel bad. Nigel went out of his way to make an awesome Shui screen. I keep forgetting to load it. It'll be here by next stream, guys. It'll be here by next stream. Next stream, everybody. It's on. Oh, okay. Let's one more. Hey, so PNC says I beat this game in the arcade. Took me about $25 to beat this. Yeah, I'd love to, man. I'd be honored. Absolutely, bro. Silver Surfer's got so much infamy. That'd be amazing. All right, we're going to do a shoey now. Now, as I said, we're doing these shoujus. They're 6% arcade. Okay. Yeah, they're 1.6 standard drinks. Because the cans are a little bit smaller. But yeah, these are shoujus. And, my gosh, I have 4 or 5 of them and it'll knock me around pretty quickly. Okay, the shoe doesn't stink. That's good news. Alright, so yeah, something different now, guys. Shouju, here we go. We're going Gangnam Style with this one. Big shout out to Chris Lindley. There we go, shouju. Now, I'm doing these because they've got a few less calories. They're a little bit better for their health. More alcohol content, though, ironically. Here we go. Here's to you, here's to me. Hope we never disagree. If we do, fuck you. Here's to me, here's to you. Oh, wow. They actually taste really clean. The only thing with those is make sure you don't smell it as you're drinking it because you can smell the alcohol fumes in that, but the taste is really clean. Oh my goodness, the taste is very clean. How you going, Hardy? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Peach soju. It's good. They're very, very alcoholic, very strong, but considering it's like sugar-free, that tasted really good. That was like, that's like a sugar-free. There's only 110 calories per soju, and it's like 1.6 standard drinks each. So, yeah, they're not bad for their health, as long as you don't have too many. Michael. So that's why I've got them. They're a little bit less heavy than drinking a whiskey. Thank you, Josh, you legend. Joshy King, taking the edge off with a shoey today. Hey, old one, good to see you. I'm telling you, I hate backseat gaming, and I'm telling you, I hate you more. Charmone, anyway. Thank you, Payron. I appreciate it. I do encourage everyone to get a green shield before next whatever Wednesday so they can pick a game of their choosing on the show. It's one of the biggest perks you get. I have to be honest, guys. This last episode of Whatever Wednesday is probably the favorite Whatever Wednesday I've done so far. I actually enjoyed most of the requests last week, so thank you for making my life easy for me. The thrust bots, yes. The boner bots, the Ron Jeremy robots. We're gonna call them the Ron Jeremy bots. I don't remember seeing boner bots in Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. I think there's a developer inside joke in this game. Michael. I don't ever remember seeing the boner bots. I wanna give a big shout out to Space Coast Gaming for 57 diamonds as well, bro. Thank you very much. By the way, thanks to your donation, Josh, we've officially gone through the Tier 3 prizes. So, because we've hit Tier 3, we're giving out t-shirts and doing a 12-hour marathon so far. And then you qualify for the top 3 stickers as well. So, the next tier is 600,000. That's where we give out yet another console. Which reminds me, Kid Jackson, the Facebook payment has gone through. So Kid Jackson, if you are still in here, up. Just remind me, as soon as the stream is done, I am sending you your console today. So I'm just going to get your... I've got your posted details there and everything as well. So just remind me. But yeah, I'm going to send you your console today. I got you. Hey, go on, Brian. Good to see you. There you go. Not too late for your birthday, bro. Not too late. Hey, go on, Dominic. Good to see you. Hey, go on, Brian. Welcome. What game did I say we got next? Oh, we got Hyperstone Heist. A little bit of a more of a slow-paced one, that one, isn't it? Well, there you go. Zemo says I've had 3 beers and 4 shots of tequila. Oh, that's all right. I'm glad that my stream wants to give everyone some alcohol. You know what? I mean, I wasn't expecting to change the world or usher in world peace or anything like that. But at the same time, I wasn't expecting my stream to cause, like, worldwide alcohol problems. I should be doing more. And so one says, last night Colombian weddings, all with lots of dancing and drinking. What are Australian weddings like? Australian weddings are pretty Western. You could either have like, anything that you see on TV in America is pretty much what Australian weddings are like. You could either have a religious wedding in a church, or you could just have like a celebrant at a nice location like a beach or a park or whatever. So, anything you see on American TV, that's pretty much what Australian weddings are like too. Although with that being said, I know America has it's almost the same. How you going, Jeffrey Williman? Good to have you, bro. Thank you so much for coming in, you legend. Once again, we want to give a big shout out to Nigel, everyone. Nigel is he's basically our community manager here at One Coin Only. And like I always say, guys, it takes teamwork to make the dream work. I could not do all that I do without Nigel. So, you know, when you see Nigel Nightingale floating around, guys, it's very important that you occasionally give him a standing golf clap, okay? You have to. We need to give Nige a standing golf clap. Yeah, well, thank you again, Space Coast Gaming. Super awesome. There we go. Take that, you son bitch. Oh, my coffee's gone. Oh, my water's gone. Where did my bottle of water go? I don't know where I put my bottle of water. I might have left it in the other room. Oh, Nick, did you really just go there with the Epps? Dude, you are going on... Bro. Sorry, Nikki Allen. You were going on the cunny list. I love you, bro, but... That's pretty lowbrow, man. An MJ and an Epstein joke, bro. No. Nikki Allen, there we go. Nikki Allen, 100 star cunny tax for way too much dark humor, bro. Everybody got a line and you crossed it. Oh my god. You have a 100 star cunny tax now, Allen. Congratulations, Nikki Allen. My gosh, there you go. I feel after that comment, I feel dirty. I need a fucking shower. I need a shower. Yes. My gosh. You just touched me in the no-no square with that comment. Oh gosh. Hey, so Mark says I'm gonna pay that tax because that was awesome. Jeez, you're very lucky to get out of that, Nick. Thank you, Mark. Thank you for being a good sport. Thank you for being. That's all right. Your tax is paid, Nick. Your tax is paid. I only save the big taxes for Payron. Don't forget, Payron's gonna always be a slave to the lender, everybody. Payron's gonna always be a slave to the lender. Slave to the lender. Is Payron still on the cunny list? Dude, he's got VIP, like, red carpet, like, entry every day. VIP red carpet entry. You know, you've got the staff going Payron, your usual table. There's like a couple high class hookers there waiting for him as well. Well, look at it this way, Kid Jackson. The first one is a warning, sir. The first one's a warning. Let's just look at it this way. We were firing warning shots. Yes. We were firing warning shots, everybody. Everything's all good. When it beat this whole game, then we're moving on to Final Fight CD. We are also Streets of Rage 1. Now, if we have a decent crowd here at the end of all that, we are going to continue Road Rash 3. I knew Joshy King would enjoy that, so... As a bonus game that Jeffrey Williman got us over the finish line with, we are going to... Not Jeffrey Williman, sorry, Jesse McNair. Jeffrey McNair. Fuck, I'll say that right one day. Yeah, we're doing Road Rash 3 as our bonus game. Yeah, exactly. That's a good point, Nikki Corso. You can't be on the cunny list when you are the cunny list. That's an interesting way of putting it. How can you be on the cunny list when you are the cunny list? Wow, that's deep. That is like one of the most philosophical things I've ever heard. Whoa, you know, that's just like when I've smoked a kilo of ganja and then I get an epiphany. That's like one of those moments. I don't even do ganja, but you see in the movies when like those stoners do ganja and then they have like epiphanies and stuff. That's what that's like. And Zemo says, have I ever been on the cunny list? Yeah, Moe's put me on the cunny list a couple times. Moe's put me on the list a couple times. Yeah. Adventure. Yes. Very important. That's what it's going to stand for now. You know what? That's got a nice ring to it, dude. Oh my gosh. How you going, Status Invaders? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Very important, Payron. You see, you do belong here, Payron. This is one part of the world where you can come in and you're incredibly important, bro. You fit in here. I can tell you this right now, Payron, if you're watching, as much as a cunt as you are, if you were not in here every day, you would be very, very, very missed. So you are having a positive impact on a lot of people's lives, Payron, in some incredibly fucked up way. Nevertheless, it's still happening. You are having a very positive impact on people's lives, and it would not be the same if you were not here. A new mod for your Streets of Rage series, Streets of Rick Rage 2, Enter the Cunnyverse. Nigel, are you writing this down? I don't know if Nigel's writing this down. I hope he is. Are you writing this down? Which one? This is Hyperstone Heist, brother. This is probably one of the ones we haven't done in a minute, so we're doing Hyperstone Heist. Yeah, Nigel's got a pen and paper, don't worry, he's always on call. And I just want to remind you guys, next weekend, we are doing the 24-hour marathon. Just want to remind you guys, next weekend, we are doing the 24-hour marathon. I'm not 100% sure what the game list is yet, but we are doing a 24-hour marathon next weekend. So I'm going to be doing 18 hours, and Commodore 64 Brannigan is doing 6, or maybe 7, depending on how long his game takes. So just a heads up, marathon next week, everybody. I'm really excited for what I'm playing on the final leg as well. We're going to be playing my last 4 hours of the marathon. We're going to be playing Oregon Trail. That'll be a nice way to finish the marathon. With the remake of Oregon Trail we're going to do for the final leg. Hey, Gon Yamazaki, good to see you. Well, I mean, it's very similar though, let's be honest. Konami did make Turtles in Time, Yamazaki. And they basically took the assets from Turtles in Time, jumbled them around, and made something a little bit more fresh. No, not Oregon Trail, the Oregon Trail remake this time. We're doing the OG. Yes. Will Peyron get dysentery? No, so you actually have to use pre-made characters for the Oregon Trail. So the Oregon Trail, you make your own party. The Oregon Trail, you have to use random characters. So no, we're not going to have a Peyron character this time. Don't worry though, I will do the Oregon Trail again one day. Easy. Write on a maxi pad and mail it to him. I didn't realize maxi pads were used as postcards. That's the first I've ever heard of it. Yeah, man, it's a great time on Torrance. It's a nice, I think games like Oregon Trail still hold up, because you're taking your community on a road trip and an adventure, and there's just something very appealing about that. So, you know, games like Oregon Trail, they hold up. That's why, I mean, that's even why, like, American Truck Simulator used to do so well. It's so nostalgic and fun to go on a road trip. We all have a road trip story. Almost every single one of us here, even if we're just from a small town, have some kind of road trip story, either from our youth or coming of age. I've certainly got a lot of road trip stories. So, there's just something about taking your community on a road trip which is really appealing. So, I think games like Oregon Trail are always going to be relevant. Always. Yeah, we will, Daniel. Don't you worry, dude. Nah, see, I draw the line on Desert Bus. And I actually own Desert Bus. They re-released Desert Bus on iPad. And so I actually own Desert Bus. And I was actually tempted to do Desert Bus, but I think that'd be too lowbrow. You want Moe to bring more shoeys? Well, pay for one then, Sexual Chocolate. Pay for one, Sexual Chocolate. Don't forget, you're getting your money's worth. These ones are more alcoholic. So you're getting your money's worth, everybody. Have to get money worth. If I do more than 2 shoeys today, you guys are keeping me from the gym. I want to go to the gym today, but if I do 3 shoeys or more, I can't go to the gym. I'm currently on 1 shoey. This is how it works. If I do less than 2 shoey, if I do less than 3 shoeys, I go to gym. If I do 3 shoeys or more, I make videos instead. That's pretty much how my day is structured. Oh, look, it's Leatherhead. Over and over I see you, crocodiles are cunny, I feel you, Leatherhead, you got me going. Anyway. Yeah, yes, I stream plumbers don't wear ties, but yeah, at least plumbers don't wear ties had a plot. There you go. I'm gonna play devil's advocate here, Damien. At least plumbers don't wear ties had a plot. What kind of fucking plot does Desert Bus have? Drive for 12 hours straight until you get to Vegas on the same road. Like, really? Monterin says, I don't know if you remember the game on PlayStation 2. They used to have a school bus simulator. That was pretty fun. They had a school bus simulator, so you just drive around picking up kids and dropping them off. That 100% sounds like something I would want to do. Oh my gosh. Okay, look, there is Yes, exactly. It also doesn't take 8 hours to play. Thank you, Josh. I'm glad we could agree on something. Chris is a cunny through and through. He's a cunny true blue. Making me do 5 sour beans. Because he's really mean. Fuck you to the moon. Here you go, Chris. Thank you very much. There's 5 sour beans. A couple of them are the John Cena ones. Thank you for that, Chris. There's a special place in hell for you, lad. Yeah, there's a special place in hell for you, Chris. You get to Vegas in like 8 hours. You get to Vegas in 8 hours and then that's it. Dude, that would be like the ultimate stream killer. Let me put it to you this way, Damien. If people can't take a joke when I play Plumbers Don't Wear Ties, what do you think makes you think they're gonna take a joke if I do a Desert Bus? Like, really? You saw everyone's reaction when I did Plumbers Don't Wear Ties. What do you think the reaction is gonna be when I do Desert Bus? Like, really? Thank you, Jeff. Yeah, that's our bonus game as long as we still got peeps in here. You want me to do Taxi Stream again? Hey man, if you want me to do Taxi Simulator again, I certainly can. Damo says, I'm not seriously suggesting you do, but I should hope not. We did Mario Kart last week with Half Price Shoeys and that was nuts. There's no way I could do Half Price Shoeys while I'm doing Shouju. They're so alcoholic. You guys are already getting like pretty much 1.5 Shoeys. The Last Ronin. Oh, you talking about the Turtles Last Ronin? Aren't we supposed to be getting a movie and a game? But yeah, once again, thank you for coming. As I said, One Coin Only is all about nostalgia with a smile and some new stuff thrown in. I appreciate everyone that's taken time out of their day to come in. Don't forget, you can support us by reacting to the stream, whether it's with a comment or a reaction like a like, a heart. If you do angry reactions on my stream, there's a special place in hell for you. One of those annoying games, I think, where the foot soldiers take way too many kills to hit. We're playing on a low difficulty. Imagine how many hits these foot soldiers would take if we were not playing a low difficulty. We'd be taking all day just to kill one foot soldier. It'd be so freaking annoying. How you going, Zero? Good to see you. That's actually one of our thank you screens, bro. The turtle's rat. I don't think the walkers are in here anymore. I'm worried my content might have gotten too a little bit too adult lately. We got the walkers that used to come in and watch a lot. Maybe he didn't want his lovely little girls watching me do shooies all the time. I do apologize to the walkers. I do miss them being in here every day. There we go. Thank you for promoting the shop, by the way, Jeffrey Williman. You're a good egg. I am most of the time, Wanterance. I mean, some people piss me off, but I'm nice to most people. Yeah, exactly. I'm glad you see that. There's only a few people I put in their place. It's not everyone. Yeah, I mean, it's exactly. That's annoying when you're playing like a space shooter or like a Contra-style game where you need to shoot things, but it feels like you're using a gel blaster instead of a machine gun. There's no worse feeling. I get you on that one. Exactly. Well, one of my favorite phrases in any movie is actually from Roadhouse. And Patrick Swayze in that movie says, "Be nice until it's time to not be nice." And I'm thinking, that's just such a great freaking phrase. What a great phrase. Be nice until it's time to not be nice. It's a great phrase. That mindset will prevent anyone from being too nice as well. How you going, ZJ? Good to see you. Oh, damn it. James says, where can I get a one coin only Buddha holster? You can go to adultx.com, bro. Go to adultx.com. I don't sell them. Yeah, go to adultx.com. Dead Jay says, I haven't seen this game in many years. So yes, I mean, ta-da. Ta-da. I got you. Jeez, that's a deep one too, Damo. That's also a very deep one. Do we have any pizza here? I'm hoping there'll be another pizza around the corner, yo, but it's okay. Yes, I found out you can change the color palette of this game. You can use between cartoon and comic books. I've got a slightly different color palette here, but the version of this I'm playing is a ROM hack. No, it's okay, Monter. It's the thing about me is sometimes I'll admit sometimes I overreact a little bit, but I don't hold on to grudges either. I forget things and move on pretty quickly in most cases. You know what I mean? Like I'll sometimes have someone come in, they'll be like, "Rick, you're really angry at me," and I'm like, "I don't even remember." Like I move on pretty quickly. There you go. Jeremy says, second day, the new job went well. I'm glad to hear that, bro. Hopefully you find your work fulfilling, and most importantly, I hope it pays a lot of money. That's what's up, dude. I just got done. How you going, Joshy? Thank you for being in here. Dude, get out of there, you fucking... He's touching me in my no-no square. Who'll stick you, your mama too, and your daddy?
Pizza power!
damn it. Almost out of here. We're almost up to Rocksteady, everybody. I'm surprised that they put Rocksteady in this game, but they didn't put Bebop in this game. I guess Bebop's on some kind of freaking vacation, but you know, whatever. Yeah, that is true, Terrence. I love the positivity, even if it is a bit obnoxious. We got the tattoo level next, and then after that, we got the boss gauntlet, which is like one of my favorites. You look delicious. I'm hungry for some turtle soup. There you go. This rhino wants to eat me, everybody. I like how the bosses in this are relatively highly patternized. We got him. Yeah, Alice Cooper, I've got a thank you screen for that scene. It's not loaded, but I've got the We're Not Worthy scene. It's an absolute classic. There you go, take that, Rocksteady. Sending him straight to hell today, everybody. Straight to hell. I need some water. Gosh. Yeah, apparently it's nice to see musicians that are really humble, and he's always come across as humble. And another guy that's humble is like David Grohl. He's like the Keanu Reeves of the music industry. There's no one probably more humble than Foo Fighters' David Grohl. Like, he's like the Keanu Reeves of the music industry. But between his laid-back lifestyle and him bringing fans up on stage, and just, he's just, that guy changes lives on a daily freaking basis. He's a pretty good dude. Yeah, he's such a good dude, isn't he? He's got millions of dollars, and he just lives like us. Yeah. Hey, God, Neo Blitz, good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Yeah, I heard that actually. That'll be cool to see how he goes. Hey, Gon Assad, good to see you on TikTok. Thank you for being in here. Oh, I didn't mean to pick that up yet. I should have waited. Yeah, it's nice. You know what they say when, if you want to change the world, do one kind act at a time. And then you see guys like, David and all that doing all these nice things, and it makes you want to be a better person. So they have a point. They have a point. It certainly hits you in somewhere special. Only a little bit. I wouldn't say, There's a famous, Asian Australian, YouTube personality, who I've actually, had as a guest in one of the clubs before years ago, called Jamie Zhu. And, he recently just did an interesting video, uncovering our country's, like, homeless problem. Since COVID, and it was just such a big freaking eye-opener. Hey, there's just so much happening that we just don't freaking know. And it just makes you put things in perspective. And Nigel says, Alice Cooper used to do a radio DJ, so I used to listen regularly. He was awesome as a DJ. I mean, the guy looks like a drunk fucked out Howard Stern. It would work. Alice Cooper looks like Howard Stern if he was fucked up on drugs every day. Oh, we could... Slight exaggeration, but yes. Dude, I can't get out of here. He's poking me with his little fucking port sword. Oh, you know, sometimes I know how to crack a funny, Jeffrey. What could I say? Sometimes. Alice Cooper was on the evenings on Triple M Classic Rock Digital. Wait, what? The Aussie? You what? So how long ago was that? Are you talking like in the 80s? Like the 80s or early 90s? Like on Australian radio? Really? I didn't know he was an Australian radio host. Yeah, it's true, hey. I mean, a lot of these rockers live life very, very fast, so Alice Cooper certainly needs to be a good influence for the next generation for sure. Right. I didn't even know that, Damo. Oh, excuse me. I'm kind of curious to know what other groups and bands and stuff Alice Cooper appreciates in 2024. Like, I'm very curious to know what kind of groups and music he endorses these days. For no other reason than I'm just curious. How you going, Patrick Kopecky? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in, you legend. Oh, there we go. I still haven't lost a life yet. Fuck yeah. How's everything going, Patrick? You bringing that big dick energy into the... big voodoo energy into one coin only. You have to. Yeah. Did Alice Cooper ever write a book? He would have so many interesting stories if he ever decided to write a book. I don't know if he has a book or not. He might have a book. If Alice Cooper had a book, I mean, I was never like the world's number one Alice Cooper fan, but if he had a book, I'd read it. Imagine all the saucy details that'd be in that thing. Jeez. Man, I love it when people give back, hey. Alright, we made it. Oh, there's another pizza here, look out. Tell you what, a guy that was really lucky to get a second chance was Will Smith. Will Smith got like famous at like 18, 19, made a shit ton of money, and forgot to pay tax. And then he was so lucky that the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air came along to get him out of trouble. Because he would have almost been done. Not that Will Smith has anything to do with Alex Cooper, but yeah. just talking about musos that go broke. He was lucky to get another life. Hey, we've got Nathan. Good to see you, bro. Thank you for coming in. Damn it. Oh my gosh. Damn it. Sloppy, guys. Sloppy. Sloppy. Tattoo causing me all sorts of headaches today. Alright, we did it. Yeah, you know, I liked MTV back in the day, guys. Back when MTV actually played music. Well, once upon a time, you actually got to watch music on MTV. Remember that? Well, once upon a time in a galaxy far, far away. Yes, once upon a time. Yeah. And so Mitch says MTV Classic still does Metal Mayhem. Awesome show. Yes. So MTV, so I don't have Foxtel anymore. So I don't just have the one MTV with the reality crack. They have the normal music channels now too. Man, hey, maybe they finally listened to the complaints after all these years. Wow, that's okay, that's all right. Do you remember in the 2000s when we had the V music channel? And then they came out with Club V, which was like the nightclub channel. Man, I loved the nightclub channel back in the day. That was so awesome. We had Club V, where you could hear like just the top 40 club jams, but then they'd also do like the Euro House and Electro and everything. Oh man, it was great. I loved Club V. Yeah, they had Channel V, and then they had Club V that came out in the early 2000s, which was like the nightclub channel. Tony reckons that was like 2 minutes ago. Yeah, well, it's time goes very, very quickly. Payron says, "Have I found anything yet?" No, we ain't found shit. Oh, here we go. We got this boss gauntlet to start with. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Taking our time. Once again, we thank you all for watching, guys. I'm doing my best to bring you the hype today, but I may need another coffee or a soju. I'm not sure yet. I might have to get Super Porn to bring me in some coffee and some water. Sure. Yeah, I love Beavis and Butthead. Absolutely freaking lootly. I used to hire them out in VHS. Oh, we had Beavis and Butthead. What channel did they play those on? I think, did they play on the Comedy Channel? Or was it Fox? Might have been Fox. I can't remember. But yeah, I used to... we didn't have MTV in Australia yet when Beavis and Butthead came out. So they're on another channel. But I used to watch them on cable and then I'd rent them out in VHS. Yeah, I watched it. I watched it on Paramount Plus. It was actually very good. I probably enjoyed the sequel movie as much as I enjoyed Beavis and Butthead Do America. It was very good, actually. It was very good. It made sense as to why Beavis and Butthead are now in the future. They explained it in the movie perfectly, and so it wasn't too ridiculous. So yeah, Beavis and Butthead now in the future. Yeah, they went nearly 30, they went like 25 years into the future. All because Beavis screwed up when he was trying to score. Literally, all the problems that those boys get themselves into is when they're trying to score. How you going, Chrissy Fieldsy? Thank you for coming in. How you going, Fino? Good to see you on TikTok. Thank you for coming in. The most disturbing episode of Beavis and Butthead's probably the one where they're in their burger shop and they're like deep frying rats and shit. Like, what the hell, man? They're like randomly deep frying rats and stuff. Yeah, we're gonna be watching SmackDown after I get home from gym, bro. Oh man. Got him. I'm very curious, now no spoilers, but I'm very curious to see if Jimmy's still in the bloodline or not. Personally, I think Jimmy still is in the bloodline. I think what happened last week was just tough love, but you never know. I'm curious to see what happens. Now there's a Whatever Wednesday request, the Beavis and Butthead game. Yeah, you know, I think I'd probably be able to at least get 15, 20 minutes into it. I used to rent it out back in the day, but it's been so many years since I've played. So, I don't know, I'm sure I could pull off a little bit of time on it. We'll have to see. We'll have to see, bro. There we go, we're in the Technodrome. I can't believe it, we're almost at the end of the game already. We've been going through this pretty quickly. I'll take it. Once again, I want to thank everyone so much for watching. As I said, one coin only, nostalgia with a smile and some new stuff thrown in. And may I wish all my American friends a very, very, very happy Friday night. And to all my Aussies in here, fucking have a beer this Saturday. And to my English in here, why the fuck are you not sleeping? Gosh. No. Nigel says, because Bon Jovi told me to live when I'm alive and sleep when I'm dead, sleep when I'm dead. Yeah. I guess so. Yeah, look at that. We took out four, five of those Rocky cunts right there. And when, what do you think Roman is coming back after last? When do I think he's coming back? My prediction is Roman Reigns ain't coming back until SummerSlam. Although, I have a funny thing that Roman might make a small appearance at King and Queen of the Ring, because being a Saudi show, they want all hands on deck. So maybe Roman will make a small appearance at King or Queen of the Ring. But apart from that, I don't think he's going to be back until SummerSlam. That's my guess. SummerSlam. Or just before SummerSlam, maybe to build a program. That would be my guess. What do you think? What is he coming back to being those cousins to take? I think there's going to be a civil war. I think it's looking pretty obvious that there's going to be a bloodline civil war. So there'll be some kind of like Anoa'i and Fatu. You'll probably see Rikishi and the Wild Samoans eventually, Afa and Sika. I think there's going to be a bloodline civil war. I think that would be incredible. Josh says SmackDown is really good tonight. That's what I love to hear. Joshy! Oh, I forgot what I was going to say now. Never mind. This soju's going to my head already. I've only had one. I'm looking forward to playing some games with Joshy King tomorrow night. Guys, don't forget, Joshy King and I are going to do Shredder's Revenge together on the Nintendo Switch. We'll play on the normal difficulty. Josh, you'll have to carry me because I haven't leveled up any characters yet. You'll have to carry me. I agree with you, yes. Debauchery Butler, yes. How you going, Gil? We've got Mr. G's Game Lab in the house. Good to see you, Big Gil. Thank you for hanging out today. Hola, ¿cómo estás? But yeah, Bloodline War Games match at Survivor Series. You know, that would make sense. I mean, I think they could drag this storyline on for about 6 months if they're clever. If anyone can do it, Triple H can do it. Josh, thank you very much for the 200 stars, you legend. What are we going to do for you? You know what? We're going to have ourselves a yeet party, speaking of the Bloodline. Here we go. Thank you very much, Josh. I really appreciate that. Man, I tell you what, Pat McAfee's just living his best life, eh? Pat McAfee living his best life. And Debauchery says, am I going to play Shredder's Revenge? I just said, like, literally 2 minutes ago, Joshy King and I are playing Shredder's Revenge tomorrow. We're doing a multiplayer stream. I still owed a private stream session to Chris and to Tommy Steiner for being last month's top star senders. They're supposed to get private stream sessions themselves whenever they wish to redeem them, or a hangout session or whatever it is that they would like. Yeah, WrestleMania is the big one, and then they usually take some time off. Like, I think Becky Lynch is having a little time off now. Rhea's having some time off, but that's not her fault. I'm really annoyed that they took the belt off Rhea Ripley, to be honest. I think they could have bought her some time. But, I mean, they bought Seth Rollins some time. Why didn't they do that with Rhea Ripley as well, you know? They could have bought Rhea some time, I think. Hey, so, give stars get yeeted, I could, yeah, exactly. I think The Rock is trying to take over the bloodline now. It's pretty freaking obvious, but yeah, I wouldn't be happy either. That's like 1 year. I mean, she was. I mean, I'd be so upset too. I think Rhea was on target to have like a Roman Reigns style women's championship reign. I don't think there's any bigger woman in the WWE roster right now than Rhea. I mean, Charlotte's always going to be the GOAT. I think Becky Lynch's star has fallen a little bit. And I think the other lady on the roster with the biggest potential is actually Bianca Belair. I don't think Bianca Belair is peaked yet. I think she's going to be an absolute superstar, that girl. So, I mean, I think the biggest realistic challenge for Rhea eventually when she's got the belt again is probably Bianca. And they already teased to that about a year ago, remember? So I'd love to see a Bianca Rhea match. That would be my go-to match. I like they're adding a little bit of edge to Bianca. I think that's the only thing she was kind of missing. Yeah. Thank you, Ming, for coming in. I hope you're great. No, Gunther's just getting some deserved time off. He's been an absolute workhorse, man. Don't forget, Gunther's got a young family, so he's probably spending some time with his wife. And rightfully so. He'd been an absolute workhorse, that guy. No, I think we'll see Gunther back before you know it. They just need to have a really solid storyline for him. Because Gunther needs to be in the main event picture now. I think it's very important that Gunther, after this loss, doesn't lose any momentum. Yeah, Becky, Seth, Gunther. It's a good opportunity for other talent to step up. Anyway. Zemo says, if only Tony Khan knew how to book. I think Tony Khan's more talented than what people give him credit for. The problem with Tony Khan is he allows himself to, you know, so he's a big mark and that gets in his way. You know, I think Tony Khan needs to be a businessman first and a wrestling fan second, you know what I mean? He's a wrestling fan first and a businessman second at the moment. And it's kind of biting him in the foot. So, I think all Tony needs to do is change his priority list. And he'll probably be a lot more successful. But he is a bit problematic at the moment. It was good to see Sheamus come back. He doesn't look like he's got any ring rust. This will be like Sheamus's last big hurrah now, so. Exactly, Damo, correct. Yes. It wouldn't be a beat-em-up game without the elevator level. Don't forget, you bloody legends, if you want to help out 100% for free, we encourage you pretty please to hit the thumbs up button today if you can, guys. That would be absolutely amazing. Thank you very much. Yeah, no, I understand. Yeah, I get it, Kid Jackson. You have a little bit more empathy when you remember that the professional wrestlers behind the scenes are human beings. Even with Roman Reigns on his part-time schedule, I didn't hold that against him. The guy's been battling blood cancer for the last fucking 20 years, and he has a family. If I was Roman Reigns, I would take exactly the same schedule too. People forget that Roman Reigns was still entertaining us despite having blood cancer and a family to take care of, you know what I mean? I'm not bitter at all about Roman Reigns' part-time schedule. I'm grateful that he gave us some of the best moments in WWE history. So Nigel says, I'm going to fit an elevator and a red carpet in my house so neighbors think I'm a final boss. I used to live in a suburb about maybe 20 minutes from here. And I was living in a new house and they were building a property across the road from me. And they actually built this two-story house across the road from me with an elevator. I think the person that lived in that house needed wheelchair access, so they built an elevator in his home. And yeah, even then, Nigel, I was thinking that's the most final boss thing ever. Like, I couldn't help but immediately think Streets of Rage. I think Roman Reigns has got a son that's almost 18 years old now, too, if I'm not mistaken. I think Roman Reigns has got a kid that's also nearly an adult, so they're spread pretty far apart, I think. I wonder if his kid's gonna get into the wrestling business. Yeah, I would say that it's probably more than likely that he will. Maybe Tamina's a half-blood relative. Don't forget, I think Tamina is of Fijian descent, like Jimmy Superfly Snooker. I'm trying to work out how Haku fits into it, because Haku and Tama Tonga, I think they're relatives, but they're not Samoan. They're from Tonga. They're from the other island nearby. So I don't know if they're in the family by marriage or if they're just close personal friends or what. But I'm trying to work out how the Tongan dynasty in wrestling works into the Samoan dynasty, because they're two separate countries. So that's where I'm starting to get a bit confused. Maybe you guys know. Anyway, we are going to do Final Fight CD now. Yes. Not fucking around here today, everybody. Yeah. You could do a mean Polynesian stable too, like you just get them from all sorts of places, New Zealand, Samoa, Tonga, and then you just have so many choices of talent, and you just have this big mean Polynesian stable. Even get some sumbitches from Hawaii in there as well. They just absolutely freaking destroy house. Alright, we're gonna go here. Alright, let's play Final Fight now, everybody. Against my better judgment. Oh, gosh. Yeah, we're ripping game save. We're gonna do Streets of Rage 1 after this too, guys. Ha Now, I very, very rarely beat Final Fight CD. It's a very tough game, this one. We need to get a really good start and do this as clean as possible. We're going to do it. Yes. I would argue some tracks in Streets of Rage 1 are even better than the second one. Just not the ending. How you going, Foosh? Good to see you. I'm being a little bit lazy today. I didn't sleep too well last night, but it was self-inflicted. Moe and I stayed up late watching Iron Claw. I've only got a half an hour left, but I finally watched Iron Claw, the Von Erich story. I will say this about the Iron Claw movie. It was everything I expected, but in a good way. The movie's pretty much playing out exactly how I thought it would. Yeah. I've never expected a movie to be as much as what I ever expected it to be as what Iron Claw is. But with that being said, I mean, we all know what happened to the Von Erichs. So, I mean, that's not really a... That's not really saying a whole lot. But it's a good movie. Your favorite Samoan? Oh, the UFC fighter. I thought he was built out of Australia. I thought he was Samoan Australian. Yes. Kevin says, traversing your family tree is probably more difficult than explaining that plumbers don't wear... Yeah, my family's from freaking everywhere, too. Joel, thank you again for another 500, you legend. I'm going to be right with you. Joel coming in as the final boss today. Freaking look out. Thank you, homie. Thank you very, very much once again, Joel. Man, I've got a lot of wrestling screens here. Brace yourself. We're doing Streets of Rage after this game, so keep your panties out of a twist. Hey, I'm Patty Johnson. Good to see you. Yes, we're doing Streets of Rage after this one. Yes, you just have to keep them panties out of a twist. I got you. Oh, okay, I got you, yeah. Guys, Chrissy Ogle with a big 500 as well. Gracias, amigo. Once again, Chrissy, I hope you're really enjoying your new place as well, you legend. Chris has recently moved into his new place. He's freaking balling, everybody. Are you gonna turn it into a bachelor pad, or what are you doing with it, Chris? I wanna know what you're doing to your place. There we go, we got these sumbitches. We're going to pause. What are we going to do for Chris this time? We're going to do this one. There you go. You can never unsee that now. Big Show pretending to be Val Venus, everybody. Big Show pretending to be Val Venus. Can't unsee it. Can't unsee it. There you go, Chris. And by the way, let me give you guys a star leaderboard, by the way, too. I haven't given you guys the star leaderboard for this month. The top five star senders of this month is Tommy Siner, then Joshy King, then Chrissy Ogle. They're well in the for top three. And then we got Jeff Tweedledee Tweedledum and Chrissy Smith. So if we end up hitting maximum rewards this month, they'll be the five people that have stickers. So just a heads up on that. But yeah. I just want you to know, Chris, the chances of you not getting in the top three this month are practically zero. So just a heads up on that for you. There's practically zero chance for you not to get into the top three this month. Pat has just got in your daughter's prom. Oh, congratulations to your daughter. Yeah, hell yeah. I hope she had a wonderful celebration. I hope she was also home before midnight. No, I hope she had a great celebration, my friend. Damn it. Yes. Yeah, that was you. You're in fifth place, Chris. You're in fifth place. So at this rate, Chris, if we hit maximum rewards, which means I think for the everyone to get this to the top five, I think it's a long shot that we're gonna get to 800,000 this month, but 800,000 is maximum rewards. That includes two consoles, three games, four shirts, five stickers, a 12-hour marathon, a 24-hour marathon, private game sessions, and the Top Star Sender helps me produce a show. You still need to help me produce a special, Chris, by the way. One of your privileges you haven't used yet, Chris, is helping me produce a special. You haven't done that yet. Damn it! Oh my gosh. You are loved and appreciated, Chris, yes. And a partridge in a pear tree. Well, we do give away a lot of stuff, Kevin. It's good to give back. You guys give me so much. As I said, I'm so grateful for everyone, even though the Facebook algo is a 2 out of 10 right now. Sunbish Army's generosity is 10 out of 10. I don't take that lightly. Got this. Try to stay alive for as long as I can. It's a hard level, man. Alright, we got him. And so Pat says I'm on the east coast of the USA. So still pretty early there, huh? You don't know what to do for that? What do you mean you don't know what to do? You don't have to do anything. Chrissy Ogle needs to help me produce a show. You just have to sit tight and see if you get a sticker. You know, what do you mean? You don't have to fucking do anything. There we go. We just got some floor sushi, everybody. I prefer these knives. The knives are a much better weapon in this. Hey, go on, Shawnee Clark. Thank you for coming in, you legend. Oh my gosh, come on now. All right, we made it out. Hey, go on, Shadow Fox. Good to see you over on YouTube. Angry Vets over on Kick. Thank you for hanging out. And Shawnee Clark says tomorrow he's going to start his full leg tattoo. Look out. Hopefully you don't lose too much blood while you're getting that done. I'm just kidding. That was a bit nasty, wasn't it? As a bit putting that fear in you. That's not very nice. I hope you do well, man. I hope it turns out the way you want it to. Oh, we got it. All right, cool. It's all good. Have I played G.I. Joe Wrath of the Cobra? You're talking about that PlayStation or Nintendo Switch G.I. Joe game? Yeah, I have. It's not bad, actually. I liked it more than I thought I would. It's all right. I'm gonna use a save here. There we go. Fucking A. Damn it. Yes. Almost out of here. We can do this. All right, we got him. The demo that... Oh, are you talking about the beat-em-up? No, I haven't played the new one. Sorry, I haven't. I thought you were talking about the other G.I. Joe game that came out a few years ago. The new beat-em-up one, I haven't tried it yet, no. I'm not really a big demo fan. I feel like demos are like a big cock tease for before the real game comes out. Playing a video game demo is kind of like having a real hot chick rubbing her naked body on you and then saying, oh yeah, we're just gonna hunt tonight. That's what that's like. That's the equivalent of playing a freaking demo. Anyway. Shadow Fox is like, bruh. Well, sorry, I'm a king of the analogies, bro. Yeah, we call that gaming blue balls. What, just because what I said might be a little bit offensive doesn't mean it's not true. Come on now. To quote CM Punk, tell me when I'm telling lies. Tell me when I'm telling lies. Sean says you're gonna watch it. All right, no worries, Sean. Well, oh wait, you mean after, wait, you're watching Hellboy now or tomorrow? Let me just have a quick drink of water, everybody. I'm thirsty. The noodles I had in breakfast were delicious, but they're also making me a little bit dehydrated. Oh, sure. Just as long as I'm the main chick, not the side chick, I don't mind what you do, bro. Just as long as I'm the main chick and not the side chick. Nobody want to be the side chick. Yes. Oh boy. I don't know, like a little bit of a belly ache at the moment right now. I don't know why. I mean, I have eaten a lot of... I ate some hot and spicy noodles. But they weren't that hot. I don't know why my belly's hurting so much right now. Maybe the noodles just gave me gas. I don't know. You think Jinder is a free agent in 90 days? Where do you think he'll go? I'm wondering if Jinder should be a big fish in a small pond or a small fish in a big pond. I think if Jinder went somewhere to like an Impact, he might be further up the card. I think if Jinder went somewhere like Impact, he would be further up the card. What do you guys think? Maybe put Jinder in Impact, perhaps. Nigel says I'll be the side chick. Well, I was about to add to that, but it'd be a bit dirty what I was about to say. You want to see Jinder Mahal in AEW? Nah, I think if he went to AEW, he'd get lost in the shuffle. I think Jinder would be very much lost in the shuffle in AEW, truthfully. There we go, we did it. Well, I mean, what do I know about anything? You think maybe New Japan? Yeah, he could play maybe the monster foreign heel over in New Japan. Damn it. Oh, well, let's use our first credit here. I was hoping I could hold out and, that's all right. I think we just got an extra life there. And Jared, thank you for coming back in, and thank you for the big 100 stars, you legend. I've been having so much fun here today, I've been forgetting that the stream's even monetized. Thank you, bro. Jared, thank you for looking out for your boy. Oh, there we go. Jared's like, okay, he's got the Pringle can meiosis, everybody. Jared's official. He's got the Pringle can meiosis. We're going to do this one for you, Jared. Thank you very much. Thank you again, my brother. Appreciate the support. Just reminding everyone, if you want to help out 100% for free, hit the thumbs up button. There is absolutely no algo on Facebook right now, which means that if we don't get new faces in here soon, we are going to die a slow death when everyone moves on to new hobbies. So we do need to make sure that we're remembering to engage with the stream. Jared says Pringle this. You know what, we need to do a Pringles once you pop, you can't stop screen. I don't know why we haven't thought about this yet, Nigel. All the years on one coin only, we haven't done a Pringles screen yet. Remind me to do one. We're gonna do this for you. Jared, thank you.
Roadhouse.
Hey, go on, Justin. Wonderful to see you, man. Thank you very much for coming in. We also got a big shout out going out to Wieldy Rug. Jared says you'll never die. Well, man, this is probably the most worried I've ever been in 7 years. To recap, I'll explain it in the easiest way possible in just a couple sentences. The good news is, the support from the regulars has never ever been better. The bad news is, if we don't get new faces in here, we will die. It is just inevitable. So that's the easiest way to explain it. You got it, Jared. Man, you know what, Jared? I appreciate you all your support, but you're like that guy that pays for pizzas with pennies. You could drop like maybe 1,001 hit. But you're the guy that pays for his pizza with pennies because you constantly want attention with 100 star drops, bro. I'm on to you, Jared. I'm on to you, bro. You like paying with pizza with your pennies. Thank you, Jared. I'm going to give you Roadhouse again in a second, brother. What are we going to do for Jared? Here we go. We got this one for you, bud. Thank you, man.
Roadhouse.
Well, it's not offensive when I explain it that way, because that's exactly what's happening. He's paying for his pizza with pennies. You never know, guys. There might be like one of those 1930-something pennies in there that's worth some money. Isn't there some like really rare pennies that are worth a fortune? There you go, Jared. That's what I'm talking about. That's what we call some big freaking voodoo energy. There you go, Jared. Finally bringing the big voodoo energy in here. Let's go. Bro, yes. That's what I'm talking about. And also this one, you legend.
I got cred, bitches. I got cred. I got cred, bitches. I got cred.
Thank you, Jared. Awesome. So it's the 1942 pure copper penny, is it? And how much is that one worth? And how many of those were minted? How many of those got minted? Oh, dude, fuck off. Damn it, I just lost a whole life without even being able to get through the fire. Fuck this game to the moon, seriously. There's a special place in hell for this game. It's worth several thousand dollars. We have some like 1960s 20 cent pieces and 10 cent pieces in here that are apparently worth an absolute fortune as well. I think there's a 20 cent piece that has irregularities in Australia that's worth about like $20,000 or something actually. And so Jared says, one more time, Dick Burger. Oh, you're going to have to pay another 1,000 stars on that, because if you call me a Dick Burger, you're going on the cunny list. Motherfucker, I don't give a fuck how generous you're being, Jared. If you're going to call me a Dick Burger, you are going to go on the cunny list. Jared, no one calls me a fucking Dick Burger. There we go. So congratulations, bro. You can add another 1,000 more to that, you motherfucker. That's what you can do. Thank you very much. This is going out to you. Thank you very much. You are very awesome.
It's too late for you. You're already dead.
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh, gosh. Call me Dick Burger.
What the fuck? No. Help me. Please.
Thank you, Jared, for the support. There we go. Yeah, you just made the list. Congratulations. Congratulations. There you go. Alright, you know what? You send donations calling me a Dick Burger and you don't get thank you screens. How's that sound? Hey, thank you very much. Hey, every time you drop stars and you call me a Dick Burger, that's paying for your cunny tax, so you don't get a thank you screen. So you can suck my left nut. How's that sound? You can suck my left nut today, Jared. No thank you screens when you call me a Dick Burger. Fuck you to the moon. There we go. How you going, Bubble Wrap? Good to see you over on TikTok. What's a good gaming PC? Ah, man. My advice to you, Bubble Wrap, is to go to a trusted computer place. Tell them exactly what you need and what budget you have, and they will build it for you. If you let them build it for you, you're going to get more bang for your buck than if you buy a pre-made PC. So go into a trusted computer place, maybe get a couple opinions from some in your area, tell them what you need, what your budget is, and they'll build it for you step by step. You're gonna get more for your buck that way. So, yes. And Jared says, last one, Dick Burger. Right, there you go. Thank you very much, Jared. Jared with another 100. Jared, I do appreciate the donations, just not the Dick Burger part of it. Oh, gosh. Yeah, all right, yeah, man, I'm really struggling here. I don't know if we're going to have enough lives here for the end game, but we'll give it our best shot. Oh, goodness. Damn, Jared went hard on the donations today, hey? You should have just gotten me a shoey if you had that much to donate. I've only done the one shoey today. You should have just gotten me a shoey. I've nearly sobered up from Joshy's other shoey, so we're going to have to start from zero again, guys. Oh. Yeah, he could have just, instead of paying pennies for his pizza, he could have gotten a shoey. Don't you encourage him, Josh. Don't you encourage him, Josh, or there'll be a special place in hell for you too. You didn't know about the shoey. Can someone please explain to Jared what a shoey is? You guys can make me drink a very alcoholic beverage from a shoe. It is a little bit expensive, however, it is very alcoholic. It's almost two standard drinks in one, so it is very alcoholic. Yes. By the way, I think Nigel has a new shoey and Cunny Tax greens for us, which will be loaded ASAP. We haven't forgotten about you, Nigel. At least not long term anyway, you legend. Shadow Fox says your favorite game in the series is... Nah, my favorite's the first one, bro. Number three just didn't do anything for me. I didn't like how they changed Mike Haggar's moveset, to be honest. Mike Haggar doing the gorilla press, it just didn't do anything for me. Oh, there we go. Hold up, wait a minute. Putting a little shoey in it. Bye! We need a shoey! Man, there we go. I tell you what, Chris is a crazy freaking... We're going to do the ultimate celebration here. Here we go, Chris. Fuck yeah, bro. That is what's up. Maya he, Maya ho, Maya ha. There we go. I think Moe will be in here with a shoey in a second. Thanks, there we go. Baby, can you please get my bottle of water out of the bathroom too? I'm out. Thanks, babe. Yeah, I'm dehydrating. Very dry today. Oh, all right, we're going to do this one for Chris. Here we go. Look out. This is a shoey, yes. Thank you very much, Chris. As I said, we're doing soju now. As you can see... Oh, crap. I just dropped that on the keyboard. Lucky I didn't open it yet. You can see here, 1.6 standard drinks each, see? But, yes, they're very alcoholic, these things. They taste good. You just don't sniff it because you can smell the alcohol while you're drinking it. But, yeah. Chris, here's to you. Oh, crap. I just spilled some on the desk. Babe, I need a towel. Sorry, babe. Need a towel. Oh my gosh. Damn it. Tell you what, I owe you a nice dinner. You're working harder than me today. I don't think I've caught her in the best mood today, everybody. Oh, geez. Thank you. Oh, my God, Josh, really? Babe, I need another one. Oh, my gosh, Josh. She's going to start getting really pissed off now. Oh, boy. Oh. Thank you so much, Josh. That is absolutely epic. I'm going to do that in the next couple minutes. Let me just get some more gameplay in so we don't piss off our casuals. But I'll get that one on for the next in the next couple minutes for you. Oh my gosh. Man. Thank you, babe. Yeah, Josh, Chris, and they're all picking on me today. Guess that's no gym. Oh, gosh. Yes. Oh, boy, it's crazy. Damn it, man. This is really not going good right now. if I don't beat Final Fight today, I apologize in advance. We'll redeem ourselves in Streets of Rage 1, okay? I'm not off to a great start in this bad boy today. And I tell you, this Rolento is so difficult to beat as well. Shadow Fox says you're drinking out of a shoe. Yeah, it's a very Australian tradition, bro. What us Aussies do. We are a strange culture at times, but a wonderful culture. Strange yet wonderful. Jason says you're a wild one. Dude, you're forgetting I was a nightclub DJ for 20 years. I've done it all. I know I'm a professional nerd for a living now. But I was a nightclub DJ for the better end of 20 years. I've lived a very fast life, my friend. I've done a lot of rock star shit. With the exception of the narcotics. I was never really into the nose candy or anything. But, you know, when it comes to booze and maybe some ladies, don't tell Moe, and all that kind of stuff back in the day, yes, I was a bit of a bad boy. There we go, we got him. That wasn't too bad this time. Alright, we're gonna... Yeah, so Rolento is a beast. That's right, he's in the Street Fighter Alpha game, isn't he? What was the last Street Fighter game Rolento was in? Alright, let's do another Soju. We gotta thank Josh. As I said, I'm not holding out on you, Josh. I just, for the sake of the casuals, just wanted to spread these out a bit, you know? Thank you very much for everything you do, Josh. You're a good egg. Here's to you, here's to me. Hope we never disagree. If we do, fuck you. Here's to me, here's to you. Here we go. As I said, these taste very clean, but they just have a big smell of alcohol that you just... Yeah, anyway, let's go. Just gonna make sure you don't sniff it while you're drinking it. Because it's very strong. Alright, we got it. Oh, soju, man, I tell you what. They are a little bit harder to drink than the Canadian clubs, but extra alcohol content, so there it is. Alright, we're good. Oh, boy. Boo says, my daughter calls Mario Yeo. Oh, Yayo. Sorry, not Yayo. Yeah, Chi-Chi, get the Yayo. Yo, Chi-Chi, get the Yayo. You know, Scarface is my favorite movie of all time. I think a lot of you guys know this, but for those of you who didn't, yeah, Scarface is my favorite movie of all time. Scarface is a tremendous movie. Chi-Chi, get the yayo. So Susan says Scarface is also your favorite movie. Blow's a pretty good movie too. I'm not a big Penelope Cruz person, but Blow's okay. I think a movie like that kind of just shows how talented Johnny Depp was in his prime. That was a pretty good movie too. What's another good movie? We've had 3 shoeys so far, Nikki LaGrosso, but don't forget each shoeys 1.6 standards. These sojus are more alcoholic than the whiskey, so you're getting more value for money on the shoeys now. Godfather is up there. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to give, like, the... Would I say Godfather's in the top 10 movies for me? Probably. I'm not going with Godfather to bandwagon that movie, but I mean, look, it is one of the perfect films out there, isn't it? I think Godfather's going to at least be in most people's top 10. It's certainly in my top 10, I think. A lot of people really liked Godfather 2. I thought that was an incredible movie with incredible acting, but I feel like the second one had some pacing issues. I feel like the pacing of the first movie was perfect. I feel like the second Godfather movie had some pacing issues. Casino? Casino's okay. I preferred Goodfellas over Casino. But Casino teaches everyone a very important life lesson as why simping for a woman is very bad. You look at Robert De Niro's character in Casino. He had money, power, good-looking older guy. People respected him. And he still couldn't keep his woman in line because she didn't desire him. So, if you learn anything from the movie Casino, is like even Robert De Niro being as successful and powerful as what he was, we're still a simp. There you go. Shawshank Redemption's probably in my 10. Damn it, man. This is a big fatty sausage fest right now. And so James says, Rick, SmackDown gets a 7.3 from me. The draft starts next week. That is pointless in the end when you think about it, but we'll see what happens. Yeah, let's just see what happens, James. Don't be cynical yet. Just see what happens. See what happens, man. Don't be cynical. You enjoyed Joe Pesci in Casino? Joe Pesci has a habit of stealing the show in his movies, doesn't he? All right, cousins. Oh, gosh. There you go. I want to thank you for all the shooies. I'm feeling probably the most relaxed that I've felt all week now, so I appreciate it. I haven't felt this relaxed in a very long time. How you going, Derek, by the way? Sorry I didn't see you over there on TikTok, bro. Derek, if you're still in here, I hope you're having a great day. Yeah, you I got you, Kuda Slayer, all good. I'm actually amazed that I've not been banned from TikTok today yet. It's incredible if you think about it. I was gonna be like, what? Did this game just glitch out? I was gonna be like, what happened there? Oh, we got this. Hey, we got Jeff Tweedledee Tweedledum in the house. Good to have you, man. Thank you for coming in today. How is everything today, Broham? Oh, Jeffrey, God bless, man. Thank you very much for doing that, hey. Sorry, Jeff, I completely forgot that you told me you were going to go and get them. Jeffrey, let me know how much I owe you, brother, and I'm happy to send you some money via PayPal or Western Union or whatever, bro. I know that's, man, thank you for doing that, for real. That's awesome. Oh, man, Green Mile is a phenomenal movie, isn't it? I've got a confession, guys. I've only ever seen Green Mile once. But even though I've only seen Green Mile once, that movie has really stayed with me. That was, wow, that's just, Man, what a movie. What a freaking movie that one was. Yeah, I've only seen that movie once, but it stayed with me. Yeah, wow. Hey, go on Retro Livestream. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Trevin says I was pressing my... I wish you did. I need some help, bro. After all these shooies, I can use all the help I can... fucking get everybody. You think Raiders of the Lost Ark is in the top movies of all time? I respectfully disagree. I think Raiders of the Lost Ark is overrated, to be honest. I think Raiders of the Lost Ark is overrated. I actually preferred Temple of Doom and Last Crusade over Raiders. I don't know why everyone throffs over Raiders of the Lost Ark. I thought Temple of Doom and Last Crusade were way better movies. I don't understand why everyone throffs over Raiders. I don't get it. I'm not saying it's a bad movie. I'm just saying it's an okay movie. Weekend at Bernie's. I love Weekend at Bernie's, but there's no way in hell I'm putting that in my top 10 favorite movies of all time. Yeah, maybe you're right. No, I'm not saying Raiders is a bad movie. But everyone talks about Raiders like it's a Hall of Fame Indiana Jones movie. I'm like, no, it isn't. I think Last Crusade is probably the most epic movie out of all of them, personally. For me, I think Last Crusade's the best Indiana Jones movie. That is just AAA all over that movie. Jeff says he also picked up a box of Krispy Kreme jelly beans for yourself. That's what's fuck. I don't even. So they have Krispy Kreme Jelly Belly now, really? Mannequin. Oh, Kim Cattrall. Oh, Kim Cattrall. Yes, Mannequin. I have memories of that movie. My grandmother took me to see that movie when I was 6 years old. Mannequin. Yes, the guy that fell in love with a mannequin and then she came to life. Yes. What was that? That was the Andrew McCartney movie or whatever his name is. The guy from St. Elmo's Fire. That was him, wasn't it? Yeah, the St. Elmo's Fire guy. Oh, and the Weekend at Bernie's guy too, come to think of it. Yeah, that guy. Oh, really, Monterans? So, how do you love Indiana Jones if you don't watch the movies then? Clarify that one. There was a Mannequin sequel, but I barely remember it too. I watched it once. Do you think Rambo First Blood is in your top 10? I honestly call the Rambo movies guilty pleasure movies. Like, the first Rambo movie was like a serious movie, and then any Rambo after the first movie is just a guilty pleasure movie. The only Rambo movie I didn't really dig was the third one. The only Rambo movie I didn't dig was the third one. It was okay, but I loved every other Rambo movie, even Last Blood. I know Last Blood was very controversial for a lot of people, and it was hard to watch because it was so dark. But I thought Last Blood was a good movie, honestly. Never Ending Story. Never Ending Story and Goonies are my favorite kids' movies of all time. License to Drive is a great coming-of-age movie. Two Coreys. Yeah, when it comes to kids' movies, for me, it's Goonies and Never Ending Story, easily. Nothing touches those two. You like Turner and Hooch? Why are we talking about Turner and Hooch for the best movies ever made? We're talking about the best movies ever made, and Ronnie Craig is chucking out a fucking Turner and Hooch right now. What the fuck? Really? You're gonna put Enter the Dragon as one of the best movies of all time? Maybe best martial arts movies of all time? Up there. Best movie of all time? Perhaps not. Yeah, Turner and Hooch was sad. I saw that movie at the drive-in with my dad as well. Shit. Nigel says if they made a mannequin in 2024, it would be called Demiquin. Yes, and the mannequin would have titties and a penis. It'd probably be called a Mafraquin. Am I gonna get cancelled for that? Shit, I'm only kidding, guys. Take a joke. Guys, please take a joke in 2024, alright? They'd be called a Mafraquin. Oh god, Dad, I'm so getting cancelled. Guys, to anyone that's watching One Coin Only today, it was nice to know you. Thanks for everything. I'm pretty sure this is my last stream right now. Oh god. I'm pretty sure this is my last stream ever, everyone. Enjoy it while it's lasting. Oh man. Yeah, so Kid Jackson says keep it. Oh, dude. Dude, I'm not going to be able to keep anything up if you keep giving me shooies. I'm going to have to start taking that Viagra. Oh my gosh. Nuns on the Run. Yes, Eric Idle and Randy Coltrane. Yes. Man, I was a big Eric Idle guy back in the day. Fuck, I thought Eric Idle was the bee's knees back in the day. Man, I loved Eric Idle. Nuns on the Run. And I had the chick in that from Uncle, King Ralph as well. That hot blonde English chick that was in movies a lot back in the day. You know that chick from King Ralph? Yeah, Nuns on the Run, man. Yeah, Eric Idle and Randy Coltrane. Yes, you're a wizard, Harry. Damn it. Oh, come on! Fuck this game, man. Dude, I completely screwed this up. It's all right. I mean, I lost an extra life more than I should have, but it's all good. Toy was a guilty pleasure movie because that movie wasn't that great, but it was thoroughly entertaining. I love the movie, The Toy. I remember I used to watch The Toy with Richard Pryor, and I'd see the kid go into his game room, and I'm like, bro, imagine having a bedroom filled with so many arcade machines. I was so jealous. I loved Eric Idle's cameo in European Vacation. You know the tourist that Clark Griswold would accidentally broke the bones of? Well, what was it? Clark Griswold was always accidentally hitting, like, Eric Idle with, like, a car and shit. Remember European Vacation? Big is a good movie. Yeah, we know, Dad. Big Ben. Hey, kids. Yeah, we know, Dad. Big Ben. That's that Randy Coltrane had a cameo in that movie, too. Do you remember when Mrs. Griswold was taking a bath and she was talking sexy because she thought Clark was in the bathroom and Randy Coltrane was about to jump in the bathtub with her? Remember? That's right, Eric Idle and Randy Coltrane were in that movie. Gosh. You're on level 5 of Ninja Gaiden 1. There you go. Man, you got to beat Ninja Gaiden. If you can, I promise you, Peyron, if you can beat Ninja Gaiden, you'll make the ladies' panties drop for you, bro. You need to go out on some dates. And, you know, your date will be like, so, Peyron, what do you do? And you can be like, oh, you know, I beat NES games. I beat Ninja Gaiden 1. And I can assure you the panties are going to come straight off, bro. Thank me later. You like when Clark tries to use his pocket translator on the British front desk worker? That's pretty funny. And I would imagine something like that happening if an American came to an Australia as well, to be honest. I feel like if like an American was working at the front desk of a hotel and an American came to my hotel and they were like, good evening, I'd be like, how are you fucking going, mate? They'd probably pull out the pocket translator as well. Yes. Yeah, I really enjoyed Revenge of the Nerds 1 and 2. So Revenge of the Nerds 1 and 2 was good. Revenge of the Nerds 3 was like a terrible guilty pleasure movie. And then Revenge of the Nerds 4, Booger's Wedding. Oh man, that game was a dumpster fire. That game was such a dumpster fire. Who's seen Revenge of the Nerds 4? Booger's Wedding. Booger's Wedding. Booger fell in love with a lady called, what's her name? Jeannie or whatever her name was. Booger's Wedding, Revenge of the Nerds 4. Oh God, Booger's Wedding. Chris says, I got a tattoo on my man sausage that says cancer. And I don't want to tell people that I beat cancer. Oh shit, what the fuck? Oh God, I'm dead. That's awesome. That is the best kind of dark humor. Thank you for that, Chris. You made my day. You just totally made my day, bro. How you going, Shane? Good to see you. Thank you so much for coming in. Yes, you have to watch it, E. Yeah, Booger got married. He fell in love with a girl called Jeannie, I think. And then it turns out he had an illegitimate kid or something, which I find very surprising. I don't know who's gonna fuck Booger, but anyway. It's all good. Oh, gosh. There are movies that are terrible, but good terrible, like the Street Fighter movie, for example. There is such thing as... See, that's what I like to talk about. Movies that are terrible, but good terrible, like Nuns on the Run, for example. You know, movies like that. European Vacation's terrible, but good terrible. Inner Space, yes, man. What's his name? Marty Short? Marty Short, Dennis Quaid, a very young Meg Ryan, but until she butchered herself with a plastic surgery. Yes, Inner Space was great. Nah, there's a difference between a movie that's so bad that's good and a movie that's so bad that it's just bad. And Stevie, I'm gonna respectfully disagree with you on that one. I think I've tried to watch the Double Dragon movie so many times and I just can never be entertained by it. It just does nothing for me. Adventures in Babysitting. Yes, it was called Night on the Town in Australia. That movie in Australia for some reason was called Night on the Town. And, yes, that was a good movie. I loved it when she picked up the knife on the train and she's like, don't fuck with the babysitter. And then, not to mention the blues song, the babysitting blues song. No one leaves here without singing the blues. No one leaves here without singing the blues. Yes, you have to sing the blues. You like Don't Tell Mum the Babysitter's Dead? That's a guilty pleasure movie. That movie was pretty terrible, but I did enjoy that. Yeah, Don't Tell Mum the Babysitter's Dead. I mean, I think the reason that movie works is if you're gonna call a movie Don't Tell Mum the Babysitter's Dead, I'm pretty sure a movie that's called Don't Tell Mum the Babysitter's Dead is pretty self-aware. You know what I mean? You know that it's gonna be a good bad movie immediately by the title. That movie is very self-aware. Did they remake that movie? I never saw the remake, probably for the best. It's crazy that someone of Hulk Hogan's, like, popularity was never, ever, ever in a good movie. You think about it. Someone of Hulk Hogan's popularity was never, ever once in a good movie, if you think about it. Not once. No Holds Barred wasn't a good movie. Again, No Holds Barred I would put in the guilty pleasure category. No Holds Barred was a good bad movie. Suburban Commando is a good bad movie. Well, what else has Hogan been in that's worth watching? I forgot, you know what? I actually forgot Hogan was in that. I don't know how, I can't remember how big his role was. Overboard's one of my favorite 80s comedies. Kurt Russell, Goldie Hawn. I love Overboard. That movie would not fly. See, they remade Overboard and they swapped the roles where the lady conned the guy to be the peasant worker. And they had to do that. And you want to know why they had to do that? Could you imagine if in 2024 you had a guy in a movie that conned a woman who was in a coma to come to his house and be his slave? That is not gonna fly in 2024. That's why the remake had the woman trick the guy. You know what I mean? Dude, it's Overboard was such an awesome comedy and also a sign of the times. They wouldn't be able to do that anymore. I love Dutch. Dutch is a great movie as well. Again, Dutch had a different name in Australia. Dutch was called Drive Me Crazy in Australia. And that was a movie about Ed O'Neill as the new boyfriend to this kid who looked like a budget Leonardo DiCaprio. So Ed O'Neill was like mum's new boyfriend and her son was like a budget Leonardo DiCaprio. And his hero was his dad, who was like a greedy money monger. Basically, he went on a road trip with Ed O'Neill, and he got taught to be humble. So yeah, that was pretty much it, really. How you going, Chrissy? We got Chrissy Genota. I've missed you, man. Thank you so much for coming in. Hope you're doing great. Thank you very much for coming. How you been keeping, Chris? You well? Yeah, I like Dutch. Dutch was great. I haven't seen that in forever. Over the Top. I don't think I've seen Over the Top. I don't know, I just thought he was like a budget-looking Leonardo DiCaprio kid. You know, I saw that kid in Dutch and I got growing pains vibes, you know? Came out around the same time. And so Chris says, I haven't been able to catch a stream in so long, it's been forever. I always watch your shorts though, bro. No, I appreciate that. Hey man, I don't know what's been happening in your life. I just hope everything's okay with you, buddy. We still got one whole credit left. Heaven forbid we might actually be able to beat this today, guys. What are we playing? Oh, that's right. We're going to do Streets of Rage 1 next, don't we? Ooh, Streets of Rage 1 next. I'm kind of teetering on the borderline. I've had 3 shooies. I might still be able to go to gym today. Well, one more shooey after this would definitely tip me over the edge, but I might still go to gym today. Chris says, just popping in quick, saying what's up to my guy, Headlock Gaming. Well, I'm not Headlock Gaming. I'm one coin only, but a big shout out to our brother, D-Wayne. He's awesome too. But I'm not Headlock Gaming. What the fuck? There's only one legend at Mortal Kombat, and that's D-Wayne, brother. This is going out to you. Thank you. Thank you very much, Chris. One more time, guys. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up. It's not too late to support everybody. Hit the thumbs up. Best way to help out for free today. Yes. It's okay, Chris. I'll forgive you, I guess. Hey, going, Captain BS. Welcome to our stream, you legend. Hope you're having a great day. This is our last credit. We're gonna make it work. There was a really awesome movie I liked with a very young Kurt Russell called Now You See Him, Now You Don't. And Kurt Russell was a college student that came out with a science experiment that allowed people to temporarily be invisible. And so what happened was, Kurt Russell came out with this invisible serum, and he used it to basically solve a really big crime. And it was called Now You See Him, Now You Don't. How you going, Judd? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. No, that's all right, Kevin. Thank you very much. And so Captain BS says it's been a great day, especially since I finally got my AC fixed. Yeah, you need to get that sorted by the summertime, bro. Definitely. Need to get that sorted by the summertime, 100%. We're gonna be cutting it pretty close here today, guys. Suck my nuts. Nothing's better than friends, babysitters, club, the people. I don't know how the song goes, I just remember it. that would be, and I obviously it's 2024, and I don't say this in an offensive way or anything, but if I remembered the lyrics to the Babysitters Club song, that would be pretty gay. I'm just saying. that would be pretty gay. We're gonna go back this way. And am I still playing Tekken 8? I still enjoy Tekken 8, but I've been struggling to get viewers for that game. I don't forget, views matter. I've been struggling to get views for Tekken 8, so I don't know what to tell ya. How you going, baby? You alright? Oh, okay. That's cool. I'm glad you spread that out. Gosh. I didn't mean to nag you for so many shooies. I know you're waking up a little bit still. Yes. I can't help it. Everyone in here right now is keeping me on my toes, babe. Yeah, we were literally talking about Weekend at Bernie's like a few minutes before you came in. There you go, Sean says a big good morning. You know I miss when you come in, babe. I wish you all got it as excited to see me as when Moe comes in. What the fuck, everybody? Come on. Oh! Damn, I just missed out on a free life, everybody. That's kind of shit, isn't it? That is really shit. Oh well, let's do the best we can on this final boss. Final boss, like the Rock. Uncle Rock, yes. We call final boss Rock Uncle Rock. Well, what have you done for me lately, Sean? What have you done for me lately? what have you... Wow, you actually like Stripes more than Ghostbusters. I would have never in a million years thought that. Really? You prefer Stripes over Ghostbusters? I never thought you of all people would say that, Kid Jackson. Wow, really? Did I hear that correctly? Yeah, we're not gonna beat him today, guys. I ran out of lives here. I just popping in quick at work, saying hi to my guy, Headlock Gaming. Chris, what the fuck, bro? Oh, jeez. All right, here you go, Chris. Thank you, man. talk about an identity crisis. Chris, thank you again for the 200 stars, you legend. Fucking identity crisis over here. All right, we're going to do Streets of Rage 1 now, guys, and then we're going to do Road Rash 3. Kuda Slayer says, what's up, ADD Gamer, my dog? Chris just called me Headlock Gaming again. Go home, Chris. You're drunk, motherfucker. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, we're going to do Road Rash 3 as our bonus game today. Don't forget, Jeffrey McNair got us a bonus game, so... I do need to go to the bathroom pretty soon. All these shooies are going right through my body. My hot body. Alright. You be on standby. You need to take viewer questions when I go to the bathroom, babe. Yes. Yes. I think maybe Chrissy Genotis had the shooies today, everybody. You see, so well, first of all. I don't have the glorious long Fabio hair like my boy Dwayne, so you would be incorrect. I don't care how dashing I look, I can never have his hair. So you would be incorrect. uh, Thank you, Kevin. No worries, man. No, it's all right. I forgive you, bro. Oh, man. Yes, exactly. He's got those Fabio locks. There's only one Mr. Headlock Gaming. I'm pretty brave to play Streets of Rage 1 after all the shooies, man, because this game's a little bit on the clunkier side. Cut, look at this. It's pretty violent. We're cutting people with a broken bottle right now. Mr. Cuddle, thank you for the diamonds, by the way. What's that, baby? No, I've played this one. I usually play this maybe once every couple months. I've probably played this game once since you've been here. You might have been watching Netflix, you not see. Yeah, I think arguably the best music. Nothing's gonna beat the end credits music in Streets of Rage 2. But arguably the best music's in the first one. A lot of people don't acknowledge that. What's that? What's that evil grin for? What are you doing? You usually have that look on your face when you're about to grab and squeeze my titty. That's the look you get in your face when you're about to give me a titty twister. Can my titties have a break today? Well, I don't like to always be touched on my no-no square, babe. Mr. Cuddle says me and my girl love... Yeah, it's a good two-player game. This is a cool game that we can play together. Oh, look at Chris being all fancy riding in Thai. Look out. Oh, what did Chris just say, babe? Yeah. Crab. Oh. Crab. Happens when you don't get enough sleep. We stayed up too late watching Iron Claw last night. I was telling everyone that we were watching the Von Erich movie. What did you like it? Do you think it was interesting?
Yeah.
Very famous wrestling family from Texas in the 70s and the 80s. Yes. Instead, my favorite was Kerry. It's amazing that he was able to continue on without a foot. Absolutely incredible, actually. Kevin, you know the one that's played by that guy from Neighbours? He's the only one that's still alive.
Really?
Yeah, everyone else died. So that's why they think the family was cursed. Everyone else in the family died. Kevin's the only one left. He's still married to his wife, though, I think. So that's good. They've been together for, like, what, 45 years? I mean, at least there's that. Probably a good thing you don't have any brothers left. Dark humour there. Yeah, I need to see that episode again. There was a good Dark Side of the Ring episode there. Good night to you too, Craig David. Thank you for coming in. Hatebreed says unpopular opinion, Streets of Rage 3 over number 2. Yeah, I disagree with you on that. I think the thing that... You know what I think about Streets of Rage 3? I think Streets of Rage 3 proved that sometimes music... makes the game, and I feel like the music in Streets of Rage 3 was absolute garbage. So sometimes the soundtrack makes a game, and I feel like the soundtrack in Streets of Rage 3 was abysmal. But anyway. Meh! Once again, everyone, thank you for coming in and watching our stream today. Thank you to everyone who's also donated, no matter how big or small, guys. We appreciate you. I have done 3 shooies already. They're very strong, babe. So it's easy to drink as long as you don't smell it. Because there's just like that big alcohol smell to the soju. But did you hear what I've been doing, Chrissy Lindley? I've been doing soju for our shooies now. We've been doing peach soju. And so Chris says, let's see if I can send you stars without calling you Headlock Gaming. Well, it's not like it's an insult. He's pretty good. He's pretty good. Chrissy Genota, thank you very much for another 100. We'll have a bit of a yeet party for that one. There you go. So sorry to throw you under the bus, babe, but I'm going to have my one and only bathroom break. Talk to everybody in here. Moe's going to field questions while I have a quick bathroom break, everybody. Here she is.
Oh, wake up. Hi, Chris and everybody. Brandon. Everyone doing? Hi, Captain BS. And Kevin, Kit Jackson, Christopher, and Rick.
There we go. How did you go, babe? Did you do a good job? Should we up her salary, guys? Should we up her salary? Did she do a good job? There you go. Chris is talking in Thai again. Isn't Chris full of surprises, babe?
Oh, Chris, thank you.
Captain BS says hello as well. Look how many chats we got loaded up right now. Yes. On the... Yes. I keep forgetting that there's no special move like Streets of Rage 2 in this. We've only got the rocket and that's it. Chris says, Star Samoa, fuck off. They're for me, cunny. They're for me. Fuck you too.
Good Here we morning, go. My neighbor!
No, they're for me. Fuck you.
Yes! Yes! Fuck you too!
That's right. Fuck you, Chris. They're for me. They're for me. Thank you, Chris. Trust me, my wonderful woman is well looked after. They're for me, motherfucker. They're for me. Oh, gosh. Chrissy Lindley says, there's a Thai restaurant near my house. Where in Texas, the owner tries to teach me the Thai language. Yeah, Super Porn's family occasionally tries to teach me a couple. Sabali der.
Yeah, you call my village out. It's really sad language.
Yeah, Josh is like, nut soup cow.
Yeah.
Can you please tell Josh how it's actually pronounced? We're going to teach him Thai, so how's it actually pronounced?
Look soup
cow. It's actually look soup cow, and what does it actually mean? It means get up and fight. It's got nothing to do with White Warrior. So it's actually Luk Suk Gal, and it means get up and fight.
Yeah.
They made up the White Warrior shit in that movie.
Yeah.
Luk Suk Gal. Yeah. Do we need to charge Chris a cunny tax? What did he just put up? What does that say?
Oh, maybe he's has a... Like a... Fuck.
He said fuck. Did you say fuck to my girl, Chris? Don't come in here and say fuck to my girl, asshole. There we go. This guy. Asshole. How you going? Hi, Hatebreed. Good to see you. Thank you for coming. No, fair enough. Look, you like what you like. It's okay. Hey, Gone Steam Row, good to see you. Thank you for coming in. This is why you try not to be clever on Google, bro. This is why you try not to be clever on Google, because you can write really offensive things if you're not careful. You know, he's trying to be clever and go on Google Translate and it backfired. Yeah. You have to be careful with that stuff. I used to do that with some of my Thai friends too. I did that once with Nina. You know that girl I told you I know that got married in Patong last year? Yeah, I did that a couple times and it didn't come out the way it should have. Hey, Aegon Striker, good to see you. You want the... All right, you got it, Josh. All right, here we go. We'll do our tie screen here. And we'll do this one, too. Yeah, it's from the same movie. That's how I dance when I'm in Thailand, isn't it? When I'm in the Thai cabaret club, that's exactly how I dance. Oh no, Steamrow says I'm in pain after a car accident. Dude, I'm so sorry that you're not in good health right now. I know I'm not going to be able to make anything better, dude, but hopefully we can distract you for a bit. I question Rick and Moe, what about the end of Bloodsport? I mean, Bloodsport was in Hong Kong, not Thailand, as far as I know. Wasn't Bloodsport in Hong Kong? King David says you froze. Back out and come back in. Oh, they ended up releasing... oh, man, that makes me a little bit heartbroken. So don't think... I won't go as far as to say I had a personal relationship with Zion Quinn, but I used to... see him every weekend. So don't forget, I used to DJ for him and his girl. Yeah, Daniel DeVoe. I hope he's okay. That's a real shame. They invested a lot of time in Zion Quinn. When I saw WWE in Australia, they did a really big angle between him and a heel Sami Zayn as well, and they were looking like they were putting a lot of energy into Zion Quinn, and it's a shame that they released him. I really hope he'll end up in another company and he'll thrive. It makes me upset. I really wanted him to succeed. Yeah, a guy I know from way back, he's in the WWE, he just got let go of his contract. Yeah. That's a shame. Danny says, hello, Ricky. Good to see you. Rough night at the field. Ghetto people starting fights. Yeah, that's... people just need to chill out and get along. Guys, we got a big shout out to Cyberfish Gaming. Look at this. We got Jeffrey in here. Fine Light, Jake Moto, Amanda, Kate, Britta, Jameson, Link. Look at you guys. Look at you guys. Thank you so much for coming in. For those of you on Kick, we suggest you check out Cyberfish Gaming in your travels. He's a wonderful variety streamer, and he deserves your attention, everybody. How you going, Mad Alice? Good to see you. We just got like 20 or 30 people coming our Kick stream. Man, I tell you, I feel very spoiled right now. Thank you so much for the raid. How's the game? Pretty good. We're on our fourth game now. We're just doing some Streets of Rage. We did Final Fight, Hyperstone Heist, and Moonwalker before. I just wonder where Zion Quinn's gonna go now. I don't understand why they didn't lose him. I mean, maybe I'm being biased because I know him, but... I always thought Daniel had a pretty good look. Looks after his body, good attitude, works hard. I don't know why they didn't use him. I thought he could have probably, possibly, I mean, he's, look, don't forget, he's also half Australian, half Samoan. I mean, he could have gone in the bloodline, you know? I don't know why they didn't use him. So, yeah, anyway, hopefully it works out for him. Well, it wasn't at the time, it is now. You know, since 1997, Hong Kong has been, yes, if you want to get, I don't want to get into the political climate of that, of course, but when Bloodsport was made, Hong Kong was still part of the UK, as far as I know, until 97. I think it was 97 or 98. '97, right, sure. Thank you, David. Yes. It's a Hong Kong 97's a terrible game. Makes sense why it was called Hong Kong 97. Because you had... Do you remember the storyline for Hong Kong 97? To quote the text in the game, this is not me, this is me quoting the text in Hong Kong 97. What's his chin? Bruce Lee's brother had to stop. What did they say in Hong Kong 97? The fucking Reds is what they said in Hong Kong 97. Oh, guys, I just got a 1 week ban on TikTok.
What?
There we go. I got banned on TikTok again for sexual exploitation and gender-based violence. Bet you anything I got banned on TikTok because of my fucking Reds comment. And I wasn't even saying it myself. I was quoting the Hong Kong 97 game. Look at that. Look at that. That's no coincidence. I just got banned already on TikTok. Look at that. Look at that. That's no coincidence, everybody. How you going, Alice, JK Motor? Yeah, I know. It's crazy. And Fush, it's amazing how well Fish does at Ocarina of Time. I think people need to realize what a big game Ocarina of Time actually is. And to remember that off by heart, that's a pretty freaking big deal. That's an incredibly hard game to learn. And Captain BS says, talk can go talk itself. Yes. Chris says, but the reason I'm in your stream is for the sexual exploitation and gender violence. Well, there you go, bro. No worries. Is this for you? I'd be very close to stop using TikTok, to be honest, but I am partnered on TikTok. Believe it or not, I know you're going to find this very hard to believe, but I actually have a partnership on TikTok. I'm probably the most least deserving partner on TikTok, I'll admit, but I actually have a partnership on TikTok. I have management and everything. The fuck is One Coin Only doing as a TikTok partner? In what? Yeah, anyway. Oh, yeah. There we go. We did it, guys. Kate says I've not used that TikTok. Oh, dude. The thing is, we actually do get some incredibly awesome support on TikTok. Problem is, like, when we start getting momentum there, we'll get a ban, and then we have to start all over again. It's freaking crazy. Yeah, so you know Zion Quinn's last man. You know when Bron Breakker came out and beat that guy in 2 seconds? Yeah, that was the guy I told you I know from Brisbane. You know when that new guy came on SmackDown and beat him like 2 seconds? Yeah, that was his last match. Now he's been fired. A bit of a bummer. Pooch says kick is where it's at. John, thank you very much. Don't curse the Panthers or the Sea Eagles today, but cool game. Yes, it is. They're all working at Moulin Rouge and Patong now. Oh, that's terrible. That's a bit naughty. Thank you very, very much. Danny says we're here for the commentary and the hot dog dances and the shoeys and Moe and awesome gameplay. Yes, the gameplay is probably number 5 or 6 on the list. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think Panthers are going to make it 4 this year. I don't think the Panthers are going to be hungry for a 4th premiership. I think someone else is going to take the reins. I don't know who yet, though. Oh, wow, that's a pretty good price. World of Outlaws was only $5, hey? Guys, we've got Mikey Wallace in here. Sorry I've not been in your streams. Here's some stars. There you go. There's nothing better than someone paying a cunny tax for not turning up. Your sins have been absolved, Michael. Thank you very much.
Let me talk to you.
Thank you very much, brother.
Shut up, I'm talking. L.A. Knight. Yeah.
I'm going to forgive you guys if you like and share the stream as well. If you like and share the stream, I will also forgive you. You think the Seagulls? Oh, we'll see. You think Nathan Cleary is still number one in the world? You know, I'm not a big Nathan Cleary fan, but he is a great player. He's a great player. And has been for a long time, to be honest. You have a good one too, Mikey. Hey, there you go. Mikey just gave a hit and run, everybody. Hit and run. This is my favorite level in Streets of Rage 1, by the way. The music is dope. The scrolling background is dope. The effect of the boat bobbing up and down is dope. This is pretty ahead of its time for the Sega Genesis console, being that this is an early Sega Genesis game. I feel like this game early on really showed what the console could do. So this is my favorite level in Streets of Rage 1. So apart from the bitches at the end, those little bitch twins, they're a bit of a headache. But yes. Brandon says we need an result. Thank you, Screen, when someone pays off the cunny tax. I think we got one. I think Nigel made us one. Guys, Nigel's made us a shoey screen and an absolution screen. And you have to forgive me. I've just forgotten to load them. But Nigel's actually made both of them. And so I'll get those up ASAP. I'll do it as soon as the stream is done. I'll do it as soon as the stream is done. Bleh! Dying to see the shoey screen. Yeah, that'll be dope. I think that was a missed opportunity for getting to put that up today, definitely. Yeah. No, I don't know which one it is, but yeah, we just got an absolution screen for a cunny tax. Man, that IRS character in WWE was such a great character. That was a very, very easy character to hate. You think about it. Government can legally steal everyone's money every month, and you got some bitch in a white shirt and tie that supports it. I mean, there's no easier character to hate than IRS. Fucking asshole. Right, we got this. Now, you're going to make sure you pay your share of taxes. Now, get out of my office. I got work to do. That's the worst part of it, isn't it, Chris? I'll give you an example. Like, in Australia, they'll spend, like, millions of dollars making, like, an eyesore, like, sculpture on the... So, we've got a big highway, the M1, that, or the M3, or whatever you call it, that goes from Brisbane to Gold Coast. And halfway during the trip, there was this big eyesore of a sculpture that costs, like, millions of dollars to erect on the highway that no one asked for, and that's an ugly big eyesore. Yeah, taxpayer money, like... So yeah, great. Ah, damn it. Oh, we nearly got there. Nearly got there, guys. Oh, let's just use this now. Hey, Brandon says, gotta love Friday nights with Sam Bishami, Ricky Bowie, and Mary Jane. Does Mary Jane put out? Asking for a friend. How you going, Sam Bish? Good to have you. Thank you for coming in. Joshy Peppers, welcome to the stream. You thought Ted DiBiase was the worst professional wrestler? I don't know, man. I thought Ted DiBiase was a pretty good pro wrestler back in the day. I thought Ted DiBiase was pretty cool. What do I know about anything, though, huh? What does your boy One Coin Only know about anything? So just confirming, Joshy King, if you're still in here, we're going to do a dual stream together tomorrow, all right? Just confirming, Joshy King. All right, cool. Wondering if I should use a different tag for the stream. For some reason, I don't know why we're not getting any exposure in our streams anymore. I'm wondering what I can do different. I'm wondering if I should even tag a game at all anymore. I'm wondering if my tags are even working. I feel like maybe my tag's not even working. I don't know. I'm just thinking out loud. Look at that, we're gonna take out five guys at once. Look at that, that's how it's done, everybody. That's how it's done. Well, there you go, it's Fatty McFatterton right here. Fatty McFatterton. Damn it. There we go, got the sumbish. Dude, really? What a waste of a beef. What a waste of a beef. I did it for the Rock. I did it for the people. I did it. Yeah, Streets of Rick Rage is awesome. We're just doing the original today, but yeah, we're gonna do Streets of Rick. Namoe and I are gonna play Streets of Rick Rage next week. I don't know what day we're doing it yet, but next week, Namoe and I will play Streets of Rick Rage. There we go. This is probably one of my least favorite levels in the game. I don't like the pacing of this level, just avoiding the machinery and everything. It's just annoying. It's not a fun level for me. Once I'm out of here, the rest of the game's pretty cool. Yes. And don't forget, at the end of Streets of Rick Rage, Mr. X, I get Mr. X's 1 billion stars, everybody. I ended up getting Mr. X's 1 billion stars at the end of Streets of Rick Rage. So it's a happy ending. It's a very, very happy ending. Very happy. Yes. You think I should auction for a villain role in the upcoming Streets of Rick Rage? Who should? Who you talking to? And then Chris says we all like happy endings. Correct. If you're gonna say that you don't like a rub and tug after a nice massage, you're lying. Just saying. You're lying. And you're a prude. I think I'm getting some loose lips after these shoeys right now, everybody. I think the loose lips are coming out because you guys give me a couple shoeys. This is the fun that you can be prepared for. Yes. There is no shame here. Oh, great, we got our full health back. I think we're almost up to the boss. Here it is. Now we got two of these blankers sumbitches this time. Here. Alright, we lost our weapon, but it's all good. The hot dog dance would clear the screen. Man, we need to be writing this down. That's a perfect idea for the one coin only video game. That is like the perfect idea for a one coin only video game. The perfect idea. We need to be writing this shit down, everybody. Need to be writing it all down. Yes. Need to be writing this ish down. We did it! Without a death as well. Fuck yeah, let's go. I don't remember the last time I got up to the second last level with four lives still. This is actually pretty cool right now. Yeah, Wolverine's on crack, essentially, John, yes. They looked like Wolverine on crack. Correct. Is it 420? Oh shit, it is 420 day, isn't it? There you go, it's Gunja Day. You know what we need to play today? Far Cry 3. And we need to play that level Where you burn down the wheat crop to Skrillex and Marley. You know, make him bum dumb. You know that level in Far Cry 3 where you have to kill the terrorists and burn down the weed crop to the tunes of make him bum dumb? Yeah, we totally need to do that today. But Far Cry 3. Never played the Far Cry games. You probably only need to play one or two of them, to be honest, because they're more like... So I played number 3 and number 5 to completion. I played a lot of number 4, but it started getting a bit repetitive for me. And then I've tried to stick with number 6, but number 6 got a little bit repetitive too. They're good games, but they're all kind of cut and paste jobs, you know? Once you've played like one or two Far Cry games, you've played them all. I think. Nah, I'm not into Gunja. The only way you could convince me to get a part of, like, the festivities is if I got some free edibles. I do like edibles. But I don't smoke that crap. Edibles are okay. Give me some special brownies. That'll do. Okay, you cheap fuck. You cheap fuck. Really? Oh my gosh, I just lost a life so cheaply there. So freaking cheaply. We'll use this. That was cheap. Excuse me. Man, I could go some more galactic donuts. Some of the best donuts I ever had the other night, seriously. No, baby, we gotta, no. Dude, Moe's just outside, like, do you want? I'm like, no, we can't do it. Just because I want them doesn't mean we should have them. She's like, you want? And I'm like, no, you're gonna make me fat. Already getting fat. I'm up a belt size at the moment since you arrived. Since Moe's arrived, I've gone up one belt size. Although she's been here for nearly 3 months, I thought it'd be worse than that, to be honest. Wow, in Austin we have a donut place that sells a 4-pound donut. It's so delicious. So what kind of donut is it? Does it have like custard in the middle or is it just like a glazed donut? What kind of donut is it? I don't know what kind of donut this donut is. By the way, guys, what did you all think of the boxing game this morning? Did you guys all like that Undisputed boxing game? The good news is when the beta's over, you'll be able to pick it up on console as well if you don't have a PC. Just a heads up there. It's an orange donut that is glazed. So it's like an orange, like, alright, sure. An orange glazed donut. That sounds like it'd have a nice citrusy flavor to it. Man, we had the best fight out of three series against that Jamie Peterson guy or whatever his name was, Postman Pat. We had like a best of three series for the North American Heavyweight Championship. That was like a drama filled half an hour. That was awesome. Yeah, you get the freshness from the citrus and stuff. And as long as the dough is fresh and it's soft, it does sound delicious. Wow, 4 pounds though, Jesus. Imagine having a 4 pound donut. Yeah, it's a good one, Josh, it's a good one. Thank you, Zemo, appreciate it, dude. Yeah, Galactic donuts are pretty good. These are very heavy, hearty donuts. And, you know, look, some of you guys will disagree with me. And that's fine. I think Krispy Kremes are delicious when they're fresh, but they're very light donuts. And essentially when you're buying Krispy Kremes, you're buying air. Like, Krispy Kremes might be delicious, but they're not a hearty donut. You go to places like Galactic Donuts, Mr. Donut, even Dunkin' Donuts to a point, and at least you're getting some weight behind the donut. And, you know, nothing worse than eating a bunch of donuts and not feeling satisfied. Yeah, that they are better in Dunkin'. What do you think you prefer, Mr. Donut or this one? Yeah, these are the best donuts we've had together as a couple so far. They're not cheap, Charlie. That's why she said they're not cheap, Charlie. They're big. Yes. We don't like cheap Charlies, do we, babe? No cheap Charlies. Yeah, are you probably best that you don't know, Joshy? Probably best that you don't know. Yeah, Chris says there's a donut place where he lives in Texas that does a 4 pound donut. Yeah. 4 pound donut. Orange glazed donut. 4 pounds. Yes. Some bitch says, I like my donuts fluffy and soft like a fat ass. Well, I mean, Krispy Kremes are probably for you then. Oh, good on you, Hate. I'm glad you got yourself a new toy, huh? I remember those Konami guns back in the day. I used to play that Lethal Enforcers. There's just some things you're probably better off not knowing. Hey, Chris. We're doing this game and then a bonus game, and then I've got to decide how sober I am to go to the gym. I might be able to go to the gym. If I do one more shooey today, that'll definitely send me over the edge. So one more shooey means video work. But if I'm on three, I might be able to go gym. Might be able to go gym. Definitely can't have any more. My fate is in the Sunbish Army's hands. I think there's gonna be some food in there. Look at that food just off the ground. What's your favorite donut, babe? So the favorite one you had was the tiramisu. The tiramisu one was very good. Probably won't get that butterscotch one again. It was fine, but I think the Boston cream was better in that. The chocolate on that was nice, yeah. It's like, I mean, if you're into butterscotch, it's fine. I'm not. Yeah. All good. No, the mint one was pretty good. Tiramisu one was pretty good. Boston cream was pretty good. The Milky Bar one was not bad. It's alright, yeah. Yes. Oh, Mr. Donut's pretty close, isn't it?
Yeah, but they're not really
close. Oh, yeah, true. Listen, yeah, alright. Terrence says he loves an eclair. We have to go to Mr. Donut. We have to stop the taxi and get Mr. Donut again on the way to your house. I don't remember now. I remember I enjoyed Mr. Donut. Maybe, do they do donuts at like the market in your village? We had to look.
They're ham, but I don't know.
Yeah. We're making plans already for June, everybody. We have to start making plans for June. Moe goes home in 2.5 weeks. So if she goes home in 2.5 weeks, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? That means I have to get my own shoeies now. What the fuck? I have to get my own shoeies? Babe, I need a shoeie! You gonna catch a plane and... There. Josh says you're gonna cry. Well, I won't be a bitch and cry, but I'll be crying on the inside. Yeah. No, as I said, we'll be reunited in her village in June, and then hopefully by then she'll have her next visa and we can bring her straight back. Probably a good thing you spend a couple weeks and catch up with her family and everything as well anyway. It's no big deal. Catch up with them for a couple weeks, then we'll get you back. All good. I'm sure Mum and Dad miss you. You don't think so? Yeah, she'll probably get back home. She'll be like, hi Mum, hi Dad. And they'll probably be like,
Yeah.
No, I'm sure they miss you. Oh, that's cute. Yeah. Hey, Chris says your apartment's gonna feel empty. It is. It really will. That's alright. As I said, we're only gonna be apart for, what, 4 weeks? Yeah, exactly 4 weeks. Yeah, so that's alright. No big deal. What day was I gonna fly? The Tuesday? Yeah, no, 4 weeks. No, I'm flying over on the Tuesday. Hang on. No, I'm flying on the... Yeah, exactly 4 weeks. Yeah, exactly 4 weeks. On the 5th, which is 4 weeks. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you're leaving on the Thursday, and I fly over 4 weeks later on the Thursday. Yeah, 4 weeks. There you go. Oh, that reminds me. I'll book the flight as soon as the stream is done. Kid Jackson, can you please contact me as soon as the stream is done? I'm sending you your console prize as well, brother. Don't let me forget. As soon as the stream is done, I'm sending you your console. Joshy, thank you again for everything today. You have a good one, brother. Appreciate you, man. Zambi says Chase is having a good season in the top 5 and a win last week. I knew he'd redeem himself, bro. It just took him a little while to get over that injury last week, but he's redeeming himself this year. Yeah, we're going to send Kid Jackson his PlayStation today. Yeah, we want to thank Kid Jackson for everything he's done, not just this last month, but he's one of our longest followers. He's been here for 7 years. Yes, so we have to make sure we give him a PlayStation. I'm going to quickly have one more bathroom break before we do the bonus game after this, guys. They're dressed up in your style, babe. It's your style. This game came out 30 years ago, but it's your style. You have a very vintage style, babe. All right, he says, well, you found your way here. Would you consider becoming my right-hand man? No, I'm not gonna be your right-hand man. I know what you do with your right hand. You really want to die, don't you? Alright, let's go. He's coming. Yeah, I'm gonna book that flight as soon as we're, as done. The sooner we book it, the cheaper it'll be. I can't believe how cheap it was. I did like, one of the flights I remember was like, it's like 20,000 baht cheaper, like, than what one of the ones was I got last year. So yeah, I have to get it while it's like, enough in advance. Yeah. And then it'll probably be even cheaper again, because I think I got some miles to use. Yeah. Yeah. What's that?